what are the goals when you start WAC play?
It's tough. We got a lot of good guys that are out right now that could be a big impact to the team, but Coach Marley says it all the time. What are we going to do, give up? We got to keep going all season. I know we got injuries, but we just got to find a way to play through it.
Yeah, no giving up here. The Lopes hardly ready to throw in the towel with just two games leading up to WAC conference play. That'll tip off in the new year. And as we tip off things here at GCU Arena, let's bring in the rest of our broadcast team. Barry Boutel and Scott Williams, ready for action. Guys, I hope you enjoyed the holiday, and I hope you didn't eat too much, get too sluggish, because we've got a game to cover.
I know I ate too much.
Me too. But we're here. We're ready to go. Boy, the Lopes were definitely ready to go against Arkansas Pine Bluff. 89-49. What a blowout.
Yeah, they were absolutely sensational. So hot from the field. I mean, shooting a season high, 61% from the field. Clicking on all cylinders, driving the ball to the basket, three-point shot, mid-range game. But I especially like the defensive effort. They did a wonderful job holding the Golden Lions to just 37% shooting from the field.
How about Shaq Carr with PPA Du out, serving a one-game suspension? He's back tonight, but Shaq Carr played all 40 minutes at 18 points.
Shaq was the man. I mean, you step up short notice, you don't know you're going to get a start. You got to be ready over there when you get your number called. And he certainly made the most of it. He did the mid-range shot. He drove the ball to the basket. I like the fact that he was able to take it amongst the trees, get himself fouled, get to the free throw line, making all 9 of his free throw attempts.
18.6 boards. He had 9 assists in the game and was a perfect 9 for 9 from the free throw line. Up and down freshman season, but a lot of ups for Oscar Freire. He played 34 minutes in the game and was very productive.
Well, he was active defensively. He's the one that got the block party started, just blocking a lot of shots defensively, patrolling that middle, allowing nothing inside, using his wheels in transition, knocking down the three-point shot. What a bounce that was. I've never seen a bounce go above the shot clock and then fall back in through the net. But he's having a really good freshman year. He's had a few ups, but like you said, mostly positives in his rookie season.
18 points, 3 blocks, adding to his team lead with 13 blocks for Oscar Freire. He definitely has shined early on in his freshman campaign. It's going to be exciting to watch him progress throughout his career at GCU. But how about Dwayne Russell? We seem to be talking about Dwayne each and every game. 31 big points in the game.
Well, I like the fact with Shaq Carr in there, he's able to play a little more off ball. At least a lot fresh. He knocked out a number of threes in the second half. But he's able to just get to a spot, catch and shoot. Always able to use his wheels in transition. Puts a lot of pressure on the defense. But those two out there together, really special to watch.
Cal Poly, the Mustangs come in with an overall mark of 5-7. They've lost 3 straight. They're led by a redshirt senior guy by the name of Kyle Toad.
Yeah, Toad, he's a good player, no doubt about it. This kid is absolutely fantastic. He's a three-point bomber, shoots 52% from behind the arc. You rush out there, you can't drive the ball to the basket, get a foul to go to the free throw line. It'll knock down 89% of his free throws. Better keep an eye on Toad.
They love to rain threes, do the Mustangs. As they come in, they are a team that will be reckoned with, as they are also without 2 starters, so that is a positive for the Lopes. Kate, we'll send it back over to you.
Well, guys, speaking of injuries and trying to battle through it, we heard earlier in the show from Shaq Carr. I had a chance to talk with him after that last game he started versus coming off the bench, and we saw a drastic change to his numbers. He seemed to do better mentally and physically when he starts the game. Scott, from your perspective, does that happen for players? Some guys are just naturally better when they're in that starting lineup. Sometimes they're better when they're called from 2 off the bench. And why and how does that all play into their game?
Well, exactly, Kate. I know a number of players always crying for more minutes on the bench. Sometimes they're in the back of the bus on those road trips, you know, bickering about not getting enough playing time or coaches aren't using me right. But when you get the opportunities, you got to make the most of them. And I like the way Shaq Carr came in. He made the most of his opportunities. He's got to be ready mentally and physically. Can't just be sitting there not knowing the plays, not knowing the sets, creating turnovers. You got to be physically able to perform. Can't be getting tired, getting winded. All of a sudden, you're not running in transition. You're not boxing out. You're not rebounding. So I like the fact what guys are preparing off that bench. I know Mike spent most of my career coming off that bench. You always got to be ready because you never know when you might get that starting call. When you do want to get it, you get that taste of getting those good playing minutes. You want to continue getting more of them. The only way to do that is impressing coaching staff. Shaq Carr's done it. Kerwin Smith done it. Oscar Ferrer's done it.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. And it seems like it'll be a theme, an ongoing theme we're going to see from the Lopes this year. Guys using different roles as they try to battle through these adversities and these injuries. And meanwhile, we're going to battle, or at least enjoy ourselves, on this Lopes pregame show here on the CW6. Don't go anywhere, because the man of the hour, that's right, Dan Marley, sits down with R. Berry right after this to talk about a great Christmas break. Why? Because he's had so many victories for his team, but also some tough games coming up as they lead into conference play. We'll see how they all fare. We'll be right back with the Lopes pregame show. Stay with us.
At GCU, earning your degree online doesn't have to be without the college experience. To find your purpose, it takes support from those around you. GCU's leadership offers over 3 decades of experience in delivering real-world degree programs online. GCU's online class size averages less than 17 students with full-time faculty. Find your purpose online at Grand Canyon University. Call us today at 855-428-7692.
Hey Phoenix, it's Thunder Dan Marley, head coach at Grand Canyon University. Coming to GCU was a great move for me. Join Antelope Nation by enrolling as an evening student at our beautiful campus in the heart of Phoenix. Earn your bachelor's, master's, or doctoral degree to take your career to the next level. Engage with industry expert instructors in small classroom settings where you can get the support you need to excel. Scholarships available. See you on campus. Go Lopes.
Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University. Visit gcu.edu/evening.
Be sure to get your GCU men's basketball tickets now. Season and single game tickets are on sale. WAC season is right around the corner, featuring great games against Utah Valley on January 7th. Primetime matchups as well with New Mexico State, Seattle University, and CSU Bakersfield, all on the upcoming schedule. And remember, the GCU Arena is a great place to bring the entire family. Reserve your tickets now by contacting the GCU box office at 602-639-8979 or by going to LopesTickets.com. Lopes pregame show continues from GCU Arena in Phoenix, Arizona. Barry Beutel alongside the head coach, Dan Marley. Dan, your team's on a 3-game winning streak, all against the Southwestern Athletic Conference. You got a couple now upcoming against the Big West in Cal Poly tonight, but you've got to feel fairly good about your team rolling along here.
Yeah, I mean, we expect to win home games no matter who we play against, and you know, we got through a real hard stretch of a schedule, and 8-5 is where I would probably thought we would be at the beginning of the year, and then you add on the injuries and other things that have happened. So you got to be happy with the way we've played and performed, and we call this the getaway game, which means that this is a game that before we go out on the road. So we want to keep this home streak alive.
It is amazing. I mean, without Josh Braun, without Darian Clark, two of your starters in the lineup, and when you looked at the schedule prior to the season beginning, you probably would have thought you'd feel pretty good if you stood at 8-5.
Yeah, and you know, we thought we'd have Kenzo, who had been a big-time shooter for us, Bubakar, another size there in the post, and then Matt Jackson, who's been here you know, for 3 years, and another guy who can stretch the floor, really smart, shoot some shots. So you lose three guys like that before you even start a game. You got to play some young guys that you probably weren't expecting to play a lot of minutes. And, you know, Oscar's had to come in and play a ton of minutes. Fifi's had to step in and play. And then, you know, Shaq, with Dwayne being out those first two games. And then, you know, with Josh going out, you just got to find guys to score. So Dwayne's been a guy that's been a constant all year long.
One guy you did mention was Shaq Carr. He got a start the other game against Pine Bluff. Arkansas Pine Bluff, his first start since Penn State, and he played all 40 minutes.
Yeah, he goes from playing 5, 6, 12 minutes to 40, and that's just the way when you tell guys you got to be ready, because when your number's called, you never know, and you're going to have to perform. And he played really well, you know, started off with a couple turnovers early, but really settled down. And the key for Shaq is he has to look to score first. He's such a good passer that he's so unselfish that he wants to get in there and get the ball to other people. But I keep telling him that if you're looking to pass first, people realize that, and they're going to be taking those alleys away. So he's got to go in there and look to score first and then get other guys involved.
Be a little bit more selfish, maybe limit the TOs.
Yeah, he has to, and then he has to shoot the shot when it's open. You know, he's a good driver. He's not very confident in his outside shot, so he's got to be able to take those 15 to 17 footers when they back off him.
Oscar Freyer is a freshman, kind of up and down. You probably would expect maybe some inconsistencies with his game, although he's had a lot of shining moments. And again, he had 34 minutes in the previous game and had 18 points.
Yeah, you know, freshman up and down, and Oscar just can't be a guy with his athletic ability to rely on his outside shot. He's been hot and cold. Some nights will go up there and make 4 or 5 threes, and then he'll go 0 for 7. But that shouldn't affect the way he plays defense, the way he slashes the basket, gets to the rim. He's a guy that's very athletic and defensively can be really good. He tends to get in some foul troubles reaching and being out of position. But again, that has a lot to do with being a freshman and having to learn real quickly. But he just can't identify himself as a three-point shooter.
So you want him to cut, slash, go to the
I want him to take the shot when it's open, but there's times where guys are closing out to him hard and he continues to shoot the shot instead of using his athleticism. One or two dribbles taken to the basket.
And a guy that's been there all season long is Dwayne Russell. Again, phenomenal performance against Arkansas Pine Bluff.
Yeah, great. You know, he's going to take a lot of the, you know, the defense are going to guard him, and he's going to have to be able to get to the basket. He's really good at the floater, pull-up jumpers. And the best thing about him lately, he's been getting the free throw line and making his free throws. He's going to get fouled a lot. So those are points that are easy for him. He's got to concentrate and become an 80-85% free throw shooter. But just continue to shoot the ball. It was really good from the three-point land
Six
last
of eight.
Game. Yep. You know, had kind of a quiet first half, and he came out, I think he had 22 in the second half and started making those threes. So just another guy that's worked extremely hard and is deserving of everything he's getting.
Yeah, not only on the court, but off the court. Apparently he's off the market now.
Yeah, got engaged Christmas Day, and good for him, I guess.
Yeah. How about Cal Poly coming in here, 5-7 overall, Big West opponent. But they've lost some starters as well in their lineup, but they can score, and they love the three.
Yeah, they don't play a lot of guys, but they got four guys who can really shoot the ball. They spread it out, four out, one in. A lot of pick and rolls. They're going to try to take you off the dribble. What they want to do is they want to get you to help off of penetration and kick it out. Almost half of their shots are threes. So this is a team that can get really hot from behind the arc. We got to do a good job of closing out, make tough shots, and then get out and rebound. And they play a matchup zone pretty much the whole game. So we've been pretty good against the zone here of late. So we have to continue to move the ball, move bodies, and hopefully shoot the ball well again.
Quickly, I know your resolutions maybe are with the Lions beating the Scott Williams Packers.
Big game.
Yeah, big.
Huge game.
Yeah.
Sunday night. Waited a long time for the Lions to be in this position. So it's going to be at home. Green Bay's playing really well. Aaron Rodgers, best quarterback in the league. But we'll find a way.
Well, hopefully it'll ring in the new year on a happy
note
for you.
That'd be nice. 2016's been a little rough.
All right, Coach, good luck tonight against Cal Poly. Stay with us. More of the Lopes pregame show continues from GCU Arena. He hasn't played since re-injuring his knee back on November 28th against SIUE. We'll check in with Josh Braun to see how rehab is coming and when we can expect him back in the lineup when we return.
I'm Dominique. I'm a student here at Grand Canyon University studying hospitality management. My hospitality courses here are giving me a high quality education from professors that I know have been successful. Being able to work while I'm in school has enriched my college experience. I feel like I know where I'm going and what I want to do. I've gone through things that can't necessarily be taught, and so that paired with everything that GCU is doing for me, I feel like, you know, is setting me up for success. To have someone say, like, I want you, that's like a lot for someone like me. They're changing people's lives. By changing my life, now you changed my little brothers and sisters because they saw that I went to college. It'll just be, you know, my greatest accomplishment, not just because it's a diploma, but because, you know, I did what no one really thought I could do. When they say find your purpose, they mean it.
Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University. Private, Christian, affordable. Visit gcu.edu.
Welcome back to the Lopes pregame show here on the CW6. We're counting down the tip-off as GCU welcomes in the Mustangs of Cal Poly. I'm Kate Longworth, and I am joined now by a guy we like to refer to simply as the mayor. You know that's what we call you?
Yeah, I hear it all the time.
Yes, well, this is Josh Braun, and we're used to seeing you do great things out of the court. It's been hard to see you sideline, but I can't even imagine what it's been like for you. How is the knee coming along?
It's doing well, doing well. Like I said, I've been able to get out on the court, do some cutting, do some ball handling, get some jump shots up, so it's been nice to get back out on the court and start doing some stuff with the guys.
Are you still targeting that return for WAC play?
Yeah. yeah, that's the goal, to get back before we start WAC play.
What is the rehab process like for you right now? I know you've injured the knees before. What are you able to do, and what do you build up your strength to do each day?
Right, well, a lot of the same stuff I've been doing with all the rehab. So just mainly been a lot of stability stuff, a lot of strength work, balance work. We're starting to get into agility stuff and doing some plyometrics, trying to just get the knee right and ready for games.
And I know we've been able to talk a little bit just how hard it is for you to be out here. You want to be out here supporting your team, but you're watching them play the game you love and want to be out there playing. How are you able to support the team? Because you're such a leader for this crew. How have you been able to do that from the sideline?
Of course, just cheering them on, encouraging them best I can. You know, like you said, you can't go out there and play with them. So, make the most of the opportunities you have to encourage them, to be with them, to cheer them on the sidelines and have fun. Of course, I want to be out there. Of course, I want to play and then go to battle with them. But can't do that right now. So we're going to continue to cheer them on best we can and get them going, try to bring some energy from the bench and, look forward to playing with them again.
And I know you've missed some playing time in the past in your career here at GCU, but when you're out right now, what is that like for you as an athlete? Players say they go through a lot. You reflect a lot, and I'm sure when you get back out there, it means that much more. Where are you kind of at in that thought process right now?
Right. Well, this is the first games I've missed since my redshirt year, freshman year. So it's been a while since I've missed some games. It's a good reminder just what an opportunity it is to come out here and play, what an opportunity it is to play college basketball for a coach like Dan Marley and play with these guys. You know, you miss it. You want to get back out there. So it makes you hungry. You know, I look forward to it and want to make the most of it when I get back out there.
I know, and you were talking about that redshirt year. That was when you were out. You're kind of getting everything, learning the system and everything. Now you got it. You're out there. The team depends on you. And I think what's been good for the Lopes on a whole, especially from Dan Marley's perspective, this team has really hung in there through a lot of adversity right now, through a lot of injuries. So how much stronger can you be when you return, and what's it say about this core guys playing right now through all these injuries?
Right. Well, I think we have a great team. You know, I don't think they depend on me at all. I think that they're doing quite fine without me, so I hope to just come in and help them out when we get the chance. And like I said, I miss playing with them, miss being out there with them. Hope to just contribute when I get the chance and have fun, getting after it in WAC play this year.
All right, well, you're being modest, so we'll just tell you, you are the mayor, and there's a reason why you earned that title, and I know the team wants you back out there. We want to see you back out there, so we're wishing you the best of luck.
All right, thank you. I appreciate it.
And then no pressure. Once you get back out there, just a WAC title. That's all we're asking for, right?
That's what we're going for.
All right, that sounds good. All right, Josh Braun, as you heard it, we turned the calendar on a new year. Hopefully Josh Braun will be back out there in the Lopes uniform. And as meanwhile, we are just watching what the team has in store for tonight's action. We're counting you down to tip off. And coming up after the break, a special guest joins us. She was named the City of Phoenix Police Force in October, and we'll talk to Phoenix Police Chief Jerry Williams about GCU Salute to Safety Night when we return. It's a Lopes Pregame Show here on the CW6. Sit tight. We'll be right back.
I'm Taylor, and I'm getting my Bachelor's of Science degree in Marketing from GCU. Moving on campus is one of the best decisions ever. Once I moved on campus, what really made me feel like I was a GCU student was going to all of the events and getting plugged into all the different things that we have going on here. One of the things that makes me feel most safe on campus is just the whole community aspect. Like, we're a big family here, and just knowing that I'm welcome with open arms and I can just be myself. Being an RA has given me a lot of experience that I think I can carry on through the rest of my life. Between my academic scholarship, my RA scholarship, I've got a lot of school paid for already. And what's been nice is that as I've been working throughout school, I've been paying back my loan each summer. The day I graduate, it'll feel awesome because I'll be graduating in 3 years and I'll have little to no debt.
Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University. Private, Christian, affordable. Visit gcu.edu.
Welcome back to the Lopes Pregame Show here on the CW6. As you see on the bottom of our screen, tweets are floating by right now. And so for all of you at home watching the game right now, and I'm specifically talking to my family relatives all here from California right now, you have phones in your hand, I know it, and I know a lot of you fans out there, you have it, you're at home, the computer is nearby. Well, find us on social media, use the hashtag LopesRising, and send us anything you got on Twitter and Instagram. Be a part of our broadcast tonight. We want to see you. All righty, as we count you down to tip off here inside GCU Arena, I am joined now by a very special guest, the Phoenix Police Chief, Jerry Williams. Thank you so much for being here. It's great to have you, and it's an exciting night, too, for the school to have you here, so we'll get to that. But first, for you, I know recently you spent time in California, but you're an Arizona resident. Back now as a police chief, what's the experience been like and what's it mean to you to be back here?
The Phoenix community has been warm, welcoming, and amazing. Ironically, I met the president of GCU on one of the very first days I came into the police department, so that partnership was there. Love California, but home is Phoenix, so I'm really blessed to be back home.
And tonight, the GCU is doing a salute to safety night. What does that mean for you and for other first responders to be recognized and appreciated in this way?
You know, in today's day and time with so much quote-unquote negativity shown on law enforcement, it's great to be and have a partnership with a positive university, positive business partner who really appreciates us. We're blessed in the city of Phoenix, though, because our residents really, really love what we do.
Yeah, and I know GCU especially excited to have this partnership with you guys. And tonight, over 300 police officers and kids in attendance. And there's been some great activities going on, especially PAL, I want to get into. Take me through what that's all about.
So we were fortunate to be able to bring PAL back. So for a while, the Phoenix Police Department didn't have PAL because of budget issues. And we sought a grant, and the grant approached us, and we were willing to accept that grant. PAL means Police Activity League, kids getting together with cops, playing, having fun, tutoring, and other things just to make our society better. And I'm so proud to represent that.
Why is it so important? And I think, too, you could just speak to on the behalf of young children, when they get to have this partnership with the police force, I'm sure it means so much.
So those are our future leaders. So those are our future reporters, police chiefs, mayors, all interacting in a different level with law enforcement. So you're not calling us when it's bad. We're interacting when it's good. And that's always great.
And I know that it's not really torture to bring you to a basketball game tonight, right? Your son, Alan, a member of the Phoenix Suns. What's that like for you, the family love you guys share for the game?
All I can say is hashtag blessed. We're just a blessed family, and I'm trying to rush home to go see Alan on TV. So go Phoenix Suns and go GCU tonight against Cal Poly.
Ed, you guys are really a family of servants to the community. Obviously, Alan making fans happy when he's out on the basketball court, and your husband, Judge Cody Williams, also serving the state. What's that like for you guys to just be able to give back to the community that means so much to you?
So we have a saying at home, to whom much is given, much is required. And we understand our different roles in the community, but it's our role and our job to give back. And we give back at all different levels at our house. And I'm just blessed.
I can see it through your smile, and I know GCU blessed to have you out here tonight, so thank you for joining us. It's been a lot of fun. And go Lopes!
Go Lopes!
Her son is on the Suns. It doesn't get any better than that. Well, thank you so much, Jerry Williams, for joining us, the Phoenix Police Chief. Meanwhile, we still got plenty more coming here on the Lopes Pregame Show. When we come back, we're going to take a trip around the WAC and see what's in store for the Lopes as they start conference action. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back here on the CWC.
There's a surge of excitement at GCU as the Lopes gear up for greatness. We do not accept defeat. We will not disappoint. We will not quit. We are the intensity brewing in the heart of Phoenix. We are the Lopes rising. Come watch us defend our house against Louisville, San Diego State, and rival New Mexico State. Catch all the family-friendly entertainment. Games will sell out. Get your basketball season tickets today at LopesTickets.com.
I am Laura Lozoya, and I am majoring in biology with an emphasis in pre-med at Grand Canyon University. The dorm life at GCU definitely helped me build relationships, and I've made great friends on this campus. The quality education here is great. You're testing your limits, but you're going beyond them. It all comes together, the sciences, the ethics, and just everything. It's a beautiful thing.
Grand Canyon University, the quality of a private Christian education, the affordability of a state university. Visit gcu.edu.
Welcome back to the Purple Pregame Party here inside GCU Arena. The Lopes at 8-5 are looking for their sixth straight victory here at home, hoping that the home court advantage works to their advantage once again. I'm Kate Longworth. We are on the CW6 right now with the Slopes pregame show. We're counting you down to tip off, and we're also reminding you that there's just a couple more games left before WAC conference action begins. And Dan Marley has said from day one, the goal this year is to take that conference title. So let's take a peek in on the competition. A lot of teams in action tonight, but last night, UC Santa Barbara got the better of CSU Bakersfield, 62-60. The final there, runners had a 17-point second half lead. Matt Smith had a career high 17 points. Meanwhile, New Mexico State keeps up that winning as they take the victory over Eastern New Mexico, 84-50, the final there. And in action tonight, UC Davis at Seattle U, Utah Valley at UC Riverside. And right now at the break, Valpo has a 35-16 lead over Chicago State. So how's the conference shaping up? Let's take a look at those standings. We'll be averaging in the games from tonight, but for now, New Mexico State still on top. New Mexico State might be the team once again that the title is going to run through. The Lopes hoping they'll take on that role, but it'll be some stiff competition with CSU Bakersfield doing strong, as well as New Mexico State. Right now, they are on quite the winning run. Let's take a look at those standings. They have won their last 10 to bring their overall record to 12-2. But right behind them, oh yeah, letting their presence be known, Grand Canyon University at 8-5. They've won their last three, trying to make it four in a row tonight. CSU Bakersfield, mentioned their strong competition. They've lost the last two, but they still have an 8-6 overall record. Meanwhile, Seattle U 7-6, and right in the middle there, Utah Valley with a 500 mark. They won their last game. And so as the Lopes prepare for that WAC play that does start January 7th in the new year, they have two games. This being their last game here at GCU Arena. They'll take one on the road on New Year's Eve, and then WAC conference action begins. But for now, all eyes are on this game with Cal Poly tonight. The Mustangs are in town. Many of the Havocs returning from the holiday break. Many I know are at home watching. They're going to be a part of our broadcast. Meanwhile, we are getting you ready for tip-off. Barry and Scott will be right back here on the CW6 with all the action for tonight's game. Can the Lopes make it six in a row here at home? Well, only time will tell. Action coming your way right after this.
College isn't always simple. The choices I make today affect where I'll be tomorrow. That's why I chose Grand Canyon University. Here I'm working toward a greater purpose and a place that feels like home. With scholarships to help me earn my degree, I can graduate in less than 4 years. By attending GCU, Arizona's premier private Christian university, I know I'm not just making the right choice, I'm making the smart choice.
Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University, private, Christian, affordable. Visit gcu.edu.
We have to start establishing that this is our place from here on out.
Hey, this is what we played before. We're better safe than them. Let's go.
Come on, go get him, guys. Go.
Live from the heart and soul of Phoenix, welcome to the campus of Grand Canyon University. and inside GCU Arena, where tonight the Lopes look to extend their winning streak to four games as they play host to the Mustangs from Cal Poly. Welcome to GCU Basketball. Alongside three-time NBA champion Scott Williams, I'm Barry Vitell. Kate Longworth will be along in just a moment. While the Lopes riding high after a decisive 89-49 victory the other night against Arkansas Pine Bluff, Dwayne Russell leads the way with 31.
He was fantastic again, just doing what he does, putting that ball in the basket. Wonderful shooting the ball from the outside. The team as a whole really on fire from behind the land of three. 61% from behind the arc. Drive the ball to the hole, shot 56% for the game, but the defensive effort was tremendous. They held the Golden Lions at just 37% shooting from the field.
Martin, you see, chipping in with 13 points, but playing all 40 minutes, Jack Carr. Boy, did he ever contribute.
Yeah, the Shaq attack. He was on fire. He got the party started by being aggressive offensively early, taking the ball strong to the basket. He looked for his outside shot, his mid-range shot. I like the fact that he's fearless amongst taking the ball, much like Oscar Frere is, and taking the ball to the hole, not afraid to get fouled. Wonderful foul shooter with 9 of 9 from the free throw line.
Now, Cal Poly, the Mustangs, they are riding a three-game losing streak. Their overall record is 5-7. They are led by a redshirt senior guard by the name of Kyle Toth. He leads his team with 11.9 points per game.
Yeah, and this is a smaller team, but they're very dangerous behind that arc. Toth is really a deadly shooter. Shoots 52% from behind the arc. It's like shooting 70-something from the land of two because you're getting 3 points instead of 2 points. But got to watch him. He just plays very well coming off of screens away from the basketball.
Well, the first of two now against Big West Conference opponents. We begin with Cal Poly before the team travels to UC Riverside. Let's send it over to the public address announcer, Paul DeNuser, with our prayer and our national anthem.
Gentlemen, and welcome to GCU Arena for tonight's men's basketball matchup between the Cal Poly Mustangs and your Grand Canyon University Antelopes. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we ask that you all please rise. Gentlemen, please remove your caps as we begin this evening's competition with a word of prayer. Tonight's prayer is led by Grand Canyon University Police Officer Thomas Fielden.
Let us pray. Dear Lord, our Father, you have created us to strive for the best. Grant all athletes, coaches, and fans the strength to pursue excellence during this event. We pray for the safety of these athletes and to protect them from injury and harm. And finally, we pray for your grace to provide us with the endurance to pursue our heavenly prize, eternal life in your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you, Officer Fielden. Fans, please remain standing as we now honor America with the playing of our national anthem. The Star Spangled Banner will be performed this evening by Jerry Bullis. Thank you, Jerry Bullis.
Jerry Bullis with our national anthem. Tom Fielden, the GCU police officer, with our prayer. Great job, gentlemen. There's the head coach from Cal Poly, Joe Calero, in his eighth season. Former head coach at Seattle University and the University of Puget Sound. Also an assistant for one season at USC. Coming in 105 and 126 overall. One NCAA tournament appearance. Here is Joe's starting five. Donovan Fields, Rich Shipley, Kyle Toth, Luke McCall, and Zach Gordon.
Yeah, we're going to keep an eye on Shipley tonight. 6 foot senior guard. This guy hit a game winner for the Big West tournament 2 years ago, knocked down a three-point shot. He's third in the Big West in assist to turnover ratio. He started all 12 games this year for the Mustangs, averaging 8 points and four rebounds.
Associate head coach Paul Morozik. The assistants are Sam Kirby and Mitch Reeves. Time now to introduce you to Grand Canyon University.
Are you ready?
Committed to you, head coach Dan Marley, his five, Dwayne Russell, Jared Martin, Shaq Carr, Keontae Vernon, and Oscar Freyer.
Yeah, my favorite Martin was absolutely sensational these last couple basketball games, back-to-back 13-point games and a couple wins. And Mama brought him some home cooking, maybe brought him some Vegemite sandwiches as well, because he was showing out for Mom while she was in town over the holiday break. Look for Jared Martin to be aggressive, not only defensively, but offensively as well. He took 8 three-point shooters against Arkansas Pine Bluff, making three of them. I look for him to be aggressive from behind the arc.
Keontae Vernon has played well. And there he is, Zero the Hero, Dwayne Russell. Third overall in all the NCAA in scoring, leading the team with 25.2 points per game. The associate head coach, Todd Lee. Assistants, Chris Crevalone and TJ Benson. Director of basketball operations is Luke Dallariva. The assistant director of basketball operations is Daffy Ball. Got your keys to the game brought to you by your Valley Hyundai dealer. Shop buyhyundai.com today.
Yeah, little black dress. This Mustangs team is shorter than a Miley Cyrus little black dress. I mean, Cal Poly likes to play that small ball. The Lopes must watch the three-point line and limit penetration. And this ain't no black tie affair. There is no reason to go out trying to look cute with this team. Make them play a strong and physical style game. They don't want to get into a scrum with the Lopes. And Happy New Year. I mean, 2016's been a beast. Woo. Just lost another star tonight.
Amazing.
Here's to hope next year. Here's to hope the team has health in 2017 so they can bring home their first ever WAC title.
Yeah, can't end quickly enough. You just gave me the news about Debbie Reynolds. My goodness. First daughter, now mom. Good grief. Fans remain on their feet until the Lopes hit their opening bucket. The officials are Sean Lehigh, Chris Rastatter, and Mark Beasley. And yet again, Oscar Freyer wins the opening tip. Back to Dwayne Russell. To his right, Shaq Carr. Up high, oh, spotted away.
Mallory likes that high handoff to start games. I think Cal Poly might have snipped that one out.
Gordon got a hand on that. Shipley to his right. McCall guarded heavily by Martin. Back to Toth. Look out beyond the arc. To his right, McCall twists and turns around.
Jared Martin and puts in the bucket.
Yeah, nice twisting, driving layup that time. Jared Martin barely gets out of position, but that was just to give credit where credit is due. Oh, Shaq Carr with another early turnover.
Shipley picked that one off. Shaq's got to be careful. Tillith leads for Fields. Fields pulls back, leaves there for Shipley. In the corner, McCall back out. Shipley, five on the shot clock. Got to do something quickly, trying to drive on Carr. Leaves for McCall. Travel.
That's the kind of defensive pressure you need out of Shaq Carr. Out up front of that three-point line, making sure you're not getting beat over the top of the defense, and then sliding those feet, staying in front of the drive.
Up for Frayer. Swarmed, looking. Another turnover. Good grief.
Oh, Lope's not ready to play in this one. Three non-forced errors.
Oh, Frayer stopping McCall. Draws the foul on Frayer, his first.
Yeah, look at this one here. His Frayer got that ball lackadaisical. Only had one guy on him, and just gotta be stronger with the ball when you have it above your head. Eagle going to the line, knocking the front end of that free throw down. This is a team where you do not want to put them on the free throw line. They shoot a nice percentage from the free throw line, 70% to the opponent's 66%. So they outshoot most of the people that they play from the free throw line.
Mustangs came out watching the looks in the mouth early on. In the corner, bounce pass, Martin quickly out to Carr, to his left, Frayer, bounce pass into Vernon. Vernon looking to drive, up high, up over the top, doesn't drop, pulled down by Gordon.
Yeah, Vernon shot that ball, nobody on the offensive glass, no gray shirts down in that painted area at all.
Donovan Fields from Newburgh, New York. Inside, picked off, Vernon leaves for Russell, Russell on the run. Off the right, now over to Carr. Carr backs up. Frayer back to Carr, over to Russell. Inside to Martin, back out Carr. Carr pulls down, drives, draws the foul.
Yeah, Shaq Carr with a nice ball fake. Got them up out of that zone. That's when you had facing that matchup zone, you have to make middle penetration against that matchup zone, or else you allow players to stay in their comfort areas.
Russell doesn't drop. Loose ball underneath. Jump ball, possession arrow for the Mustangs.
Yeah, and Frayer really was the guy that got up on that basketball. I mentioned the two before, there was nobody in the offensive glass. This time Frayer jumped, quick jump in there. Got just enough of it there with Meagle there to tie him up. So even though they didn't get position, it still is a very valuable play, because next time out there's a jump ball situation, Lopes will have the ball.
Scott wants to sit down. Shipley driving, kicks out, Fields in the corner, he'll come back out, slashes, trying to work on Russell, pulled out, look out, long range shot off the mark, big time by Toe. We'll see him hit, try it from 3-point land, plenty. Carr slashing in, left hand and in, take a seat.
Oh, I think that might be Shaq Carr's strength right now. His ability to get through a crevice and get to the basket, unlike, just like Dwayne Russell, but GC doesn't have a lot of players that can get through small little cracks and get to the basket, so it's nice to have another penetrator in that starting lineup.
Shipley to his left, inside, Gordon, McCall. Oh, long distance, rebound, pulled down Carr, up to Russell. Jared Martin behind him, but thankfully went off McCall's hands. It'll inbound now for the Lopes.
Yeah, it was one of those that McCall could have let go out of bounds, but just instinctively you see the ball flashing by your chin. You want to try to get a hand up on it, and you know, he could have just let that one go.
Folks wearing their all grays. Martin from the arc trying to drive in on Gordon. out in front. Keontae Vernon right hand, underhand, off the glass, and in. We're tied at four.
When you're struggling with turnovers and outside shots, that's what you got to do. You got to drive that ball hard to the basket. Back-to-back point-blank layups for the Lopes.
Shipley denied, baseline in the corner. Slashing in out to McCall. He drives, trying to move over the top of Martin. And up over the top.
Yeah, Jared Martin does a good job challenging the shot without fouling and then causing the over the back. McCall's trying to get that basketball back. He wanted that layup.
We have tied at four with 15:41 to go. Let's send it over to Kate Longworth.
All right, thank you guys. I am joined by GCU swim and dive coach Steve Schaefer. Thank you so much for being here and welcome back. You just returned from Windsor, Canada for the World Swimming Championships, and there were many records broken. Take me through that.
Yeah, it was great. We had three kids there. Jade Howard was representing Zambia. Yusuf and Mazenel Kamash were representing Egypt. Jade set four records in her events. And Yusuf set three in his breaststroke events. They did great.
Yeah, you also had 13 qualify for the AT&T Winter Nationals. How did they do there?
They did fantastic. We had our first top three finish ever for an individual and relays. Mark Nikolaev was third in the 100 backstroke. Our two medley relays were third. Our women got their first podium appearance ever, so it was a really good performance for everybody.
And as we turn the calendar on a new month and a new year, you guys have some big meets coming up, specifically at BYU and Notre Dame. What are you anticipating?
Yeah, BYU is always tough going up there to altitude. We surprised them here last year on the men's side and beat them. The women's meet have been close, but haven't quite done it yet, so we're going to go up there and see what we can do.
And when you're breaking world records, I can only imagine what the goal is come the WAC championship in February.
WACs, we're looking to kind of hold on where we were last year. We're redshirting two guys, one girl this year for NC2As next year. So if we can just finish where we are and move up a place, we'll be really happy with that.
All right, well, we're wishing you the best of luck. Always great to see you out.
Thank you so much.
All right, well, Barry, we've known lately just how great GCU is across the board in all athletics, but swimming especially. Not just grabbing attention here locally or even nationally, but internationally. What a program they've established.
No doubt. The recruiting internationally is just an amazing story, not only for Steve and his staff, but also for Greg Prudhomme and his staff with men's and women's tennis. And, of course, Steve had just a dream come true attending the Rio Olympics and walking in that opening ceremonies with Jade Howard for Team Zambia. Freyer in the corner, Martin inside. Ooh, Keontae Vernon loses the handle, goes out of bounds.
Well, that was good ball movement around the perimeter. I like the fact that they were trying to pass that thing down to the big fella underneath. Just got to be a little crisper with that pass. Keontae Vernon couldn't get that mitt on it, corral that basketball. Nice play coming out of that timeout. In the last game when they played the Arkansas Pine Buffers, who played a lot of zone defense, it took GCU a while to figure out that riddle and how to beat that zone defense. So seen some early struggles here in this one.
Victor Joseph now in for the Mustangs. He's got the basketball. Guarded by Russell. Picked off, Vernon came out. Joseph trying to get it away, he's gonna draw the foul.
Joseph was hammering on big Keontae Vernon with less to his midsection, trying to get the official to call the foul, trying to prevent the big fella going down and dunking that one on him. I think after about the third or fourth attempt of reaching in there, he finally called the foul, so it would be baseline out of bounds. That was kind of funny.
115 to go, opening half. Jack Carr slashing underneath Keontae Vernon off the glass. Yes.
Holy moly, Shaq Carr is becoming a dish man. Nine assists a game ago against Pine Bluff, and then off to a spoon feeding the big fella underneath that time down the floor.
Lopes on a 6-0 run. 3-point attempt off the mark. Rebound, Martin, oh, battling after it. Pulled down by the Mustangs. McCulligan, too heavy. This time Martin. Rose. Big time fall by Alex Abrams.
Now, this is the physical battle I wanted to see tonight. Bodies flying around.
Oh, you love that.
I sure do. That's basketball. With a little football mixed.
Carr motioning. Martin in the corner. He's going to try the three. It's short. Oh, banking it! Thought it was coming up short.
Oh,
When you're golden, you're having that type of year, everything's going to come up, Roses. Yeah,
this is one guy that's loving 2016. A year ago, he was assist guy. He was a setup guy. This year, the 2016 season, he's come out fired. Everything he throws up seems like it goes in.
Oh, Abrams with the rebound on that one. He's underneath right now, and he muscles his way in. Alex Abrams.
Got ourselves a basketball game tonight. I like the way this game's being played right now. A couple early turnovers I'm not real pleased with on GCU in Cal Poly side, but for the most part, these guys are fighting hard.
Russell stops, pops, and he connects!
Russell, all he needs to get is a little taste of that ball going in the basket, and he wants a lot more. You'll start to see the points pile up here. Got four now. Wouldn't be surprised if he's in the 14 to 16 point range by the end of this first half.
Jones over to Shipley. Shipley slashes his way in underneath, up high, and it some way, somehow made its way in.
Coach Marley won't be real happy about that one. A knifing, driving layup that started outside the arc.
11-8 is the score. Let's send it over to Kate Longworth.
Of the year he's having, Dwayne Russell, obviously just excited to still be in that Lopes uniform after getting that extra year of eligibility to play with the team. He's gone out there really taking ownership of this team, making things happen. And guys, I don't know what you did for your wife for Christmas, but what? Dwayne Russell might have won up to with his girlfriend as he popped the question to Alexis Roberts, asking if she would spend the rest of her life with Dwayne Russell. That's right, he is engaged. And this is a picture of actually the GCU women's soccer player. She is a junior, Alexis, so we congratulate the two of them. And I don't know, Scott, you talked about how great 2016's been for him. He's ending it on a pretty high note, I'd say.
Wow, I will say it most definitely. High praise, look at that big three right there. High praise from Rick Pitino, and then he goes out and gets himself an engagement ring, and the girl said yes. Pretty girl, by the way, too. He might have outkicked his coverage on that one.
Ooh, Vernon stoned underneath by Abrams. Shipley driving.
Ooh, Carr got a hand on it. Reach in.
Oh, Freyer. Freyer called. He pointed right at Carr. Both started 0 for 2 since they're 5-5, 5-6.
Yeah, Vernon with one foul and Freyer with one foul, so nobody has two yet, but you got to keep an eye on Keontae. He has to hedge out. Sometimes he picks up fouls some too far away from the basket.
Toe pulled out, leaves for Rich Shipley. Shipley to his left. Driving baseline underneath the bucket, back out. Joseph. Pulls back beyond the arc. 6-5-4. Keontae comes out. They've got to move quickly in the corner. Oh, at the buzzer.
You play great defense for 34 and a half seconds, and then that corner pocket three is the three you would not choose to have to give up, but it's the easiest shot on the floor, and the Mustangs drain it.
Jakob Nijo. Freyer looking for three. Off the rim, rebound, pulled. Oh.
That's Vernon. That reach in there by Vernon. Unfortunately, that's going to be a second foul. Got in a little foul trouble a couple games ago. Kerwin Smith came off that bench and did a great job.
Timeout on the floor. Teams are knotted at 11. 11:50 to go, opening half. The Lopes looking to extend their winning streak to four games. The Mustangs trying to halt their three-game slide. Stick around.
I'm Dewey, a student here at GCU studying communications. My dad graduated from GCU in 2009, and he is definitely bleeding purple. He loves GCU to the max. Me choosing to follow in his footsteps was the best idea I could have chosen. I absolutely love sports, playing them and watching them, and I could talk about them all day. GCU has made it possible for me to pursue my passion of becoming a sports broadcaster. The program they had here and the direction it could take me was exactly what I wanted and what I needed. Knowing that I could talk to a professor or a counselor about literally anything that has to do with my academia or even just my personal life was encouraging and exciting to know. The friends and the roommates that I've had in the last 3 years have made my quality of life 1,000 times better. I am a GCU Lope, and I will forever always be one.
Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University. Private, Christian, affordable. Visit gcu.edu.
Grand Canyon men's basketball is brought to you by your Valet Hyundai dealers. For a limited time, every day is Black Friday. Shop by Hyundai.com today. And by Canyon State Credit Union, committed to you. Barry Beutel, Scott Williams, Kate Longworth with you from GCU Arena in Phoenix, Arizona. As Lopes close out their 2016 home slate here against the first of two Big West Conference opponents. They'll be traveling to UC Riverside on New Year's Eve, closing out 2016.
Yeah, I'll be happy to see this year go. just hasn't been one that I care to remember. We lost a lot of very famous people that contributed a lot to our society.
Joseph to Shipley. Shipley cuts back in. Joseph stops, pops inside the arc. Too heavy. Pulled down by Kerwin Smith in the game.
Yeah, Kerwin Smith came in for Keontae Vernon. Kurt Vernon was hot. I mean, Vernon and Russell, they had 9 points on 4-7 shooting combined. And we'll see what Smith can do. He was wonderful on the glass and using his length along the basket.
Frayer turns and nothing but net.
Anytime you're working behind that defense, that zone defense, behind their field of vision, jumping into the middle like that, nice body control, getting himself and his shoulder squared to the basket, he knocked it down.
Shipley to his right. Inside Abrams, can't move on Kerwin. Oh my.
Abrams got a even
Kerwin line going in the paint. Looking over at the official. Shipley right in and in.
Kerwin Smith got robbed. A great defensive effort, went for naught. I thought that Abrams was in the key too long.
Camping out in there. Russell.
Coach Marley was hot about that. The officials an earfill.
Frayer turning and all alone connecting.
This kid's special. Hey, as a freshman, to be able to do some of the things with his body that he can do, and it's not just all athleticism. A lot of it is control.
Oh, Shipley lost the handle. Russell quickly up to Kerwin. Oh, he can't get the shot off.
I think Kerwin had a Mustangs player on top of that basketball in his arms as he tried to go up, but Oscar Frayer gets working from behind that defense there and has got the ability to be able to turn that right shoulder back to the basket, fire that thing up there, and it's falling through back rim and down. Well, we call him K-Dunk for a reason. He has worked on his free throw stroke and has not been rewarded with the success from the line that he would have liked.
8 of 28 now.
Yeah, under 30% shooting. I was hoping that he would find his way north of 50% before the wax started. It would give him some more confidence to be able to try to take guys to the basket and get fouled, not worry about going to the line and making a couple free throws. But really right now, just stuck on that launch pad, can't get himself started.
Joseph pulls back out. Driving again on Frayer. Lost the handle on it. Joseph got in the way. Frayer.
Yeah, Frayer got fouled, I believe.
Oh, he did Frayer. By Joseph.
Yeah, Frayer got fouled, pivoting, trying to find over. The outlet man. But I think it was a good foul by Joseph, if you can call that a good foul, because it stopped what could have been a fast break opportunity for the Lopes after that rebound.
Inside, oh, Kerwin couldn't put it down. Tried to turn around. Got a hand on it. Hollingsworth in the game now.
Well, I like this left shoulder turn to right hand hook, but those are small Cal Poly players underneath there. Just go up there. Don't worry about getting fouled and having to go to the free throw line. Put him in the basket with him.
Shipley back out. Fields three. Connects.
That's nice. Inside out basketball that time by the Mustangs. Anytime that ball gets below the free throw line, puts a lot of pressure on the defense. They got to suck down to that basketball. That Fields a good opportunity to get a clean look at a three.
Fields 43%. Three-point shooter. Russell to his right. Fifi Adu in the game. Inside Kerwin. Smith underneath. Muscles his way out. Not there. Tried to tip it back and couldn't get it home. Shipley brings it up.
Well, they keep going to the big fella underneath. He's going to put one of those down.
Ooh, Frayer. Fields tried to lay it in. Loose ball, Kerwin Smith.
Did Fur jump over him?
I think he did.
My goodness. I told you about his athleticism. I think he just hurdled a player.
Ooh, be careful. Bounce pass. Kerwin Smith fouled by Shipley. Pretty heavy.
Well, Frere tries to go out, close out of that three-point shot. Runs him, he went right over Holfield's shoulder there. And it goes one by a strong foul underneath there. By Shipley, and that's what you'd want to do to the big fella, not prevent an easy opportunity, make him go to the line and earn them both. And this is where Kerwin Smith's got to start proving that he can knock him down.
There you go. Let's send it over to Kate.
Well, guys, the good news is Shaq Carr is off the training table, back on the bench. He is cleared to go back in, but he did suffer a bruised right foot.
Good grief.
Good. Ankles nice to see him. Thighs, mouths. It seems like these GCU players have been getting banged up in the early goings in some of these recent games during this homestand.
Kerwin knocking both of them in.
I like that. See, that gives him confidence the rest of the game to continue to finish strong around the basket.
Lead is one for GCU. Fields trying to move over Martin. Nijo just inside the arc. Good rebound, push into Martin's hand.
And Frere didn't get that one, but he certainly was in the field of vision of the shooter.
Bringer, three. Pulled down by Fields. Eight and counting on the first half clock. Long three off the front of the rim. Rebound, Fifi Adu. Fifi Adu is right, he's fouled by Fields.
Oh, that was a bad foul. That put him over the limit there. They're shooting the one and one. I think Fields thought he was going to stop the break and it would be side out of bounds, but that was the 17th foul on the Mustangs, and that will send Fifi Adu, who's a good free throw shooter, to the line.
17-16 is the score. The Lopes looking strong here early on in this game. It's tight. Mustangs again came out, punched him in the mouth, but their defense definitely responded, and they found some hot hitting as far as getting back in the game points-wise.
Yeah, I mean, I like that. They were slow with a couple of those turnovers there early. In fact, three in a row to start the basketball game, but they ratchet up the defensive end, and that's how you get back in the game. You get back in the game on the defensive side when you're not hitting shots. Let's go to the telestrator here. We can see that. You know, when you got good guys that can get out here and put ball pressure on here like Russell can, it really helps the back line of the defense. Now, everybody over here lined up on this side is watching that ball there. And then Keontae Vernon does such a good job hedging out. That ball now is in a double team that is 35 feet away from the basket. Makes the back line of the defensive jobs easy. You got a lot of interceptors and a goalkeeper, and then you close out on the shot. You got burned by the three-point shotter, but sometimes good O beats good D. You'll like to see that. You'll win more of those battles than you lose.
You definitely want them to see continuing to play just that style of defense. Fans, be sure to tune into the Dan Marley Show for an up-close look at the GCU men's basketball team. Recaps of recent games, including the December homestand. We'll hear from head coach Dan Marley. Stay tuned for upcoming shows on the 7th and 21st of January, February 4th and 25th, and a final season recap show all coming your way. It's the Dan Marley Show on CW6. GCU got back into the game, but not a bit cold. They're old for the last four. And coach Dan Marley hoping to close out his 2016 with his Lions taking care of your Packers.
Ain't gonna happen. Packers are red hot right now. Winners of five straight. And even though the game is at Ford Field in Detroit,
yeah,
don't think it's gonna matter. Wow. Aaron Rodgers is playing at the MVP level that he played at a couple years ago.
So you basically want us to relax.
R-E-L-A-X. Just like Fifi does, Adu does at the free throw line.
Oh my goodness. There we did it. We
tried to get it in there and yep. I jinxed him.
82% free throw shooter.
What a thunk.
Yep.
Did I have to sit out the game against Arkansas Pine Bluff? And sometimes when you're not in there in that game action, you're breathing heavy. You have to go to the free throw line and knock some free throws down. It becomes a bit more difficult.
Toe trying to move on Carr. Kerwin comes out for support. Surrounded. Bounce pass off of the foot.
Yeah, Nijo. Well, we threw up that good defense.
coming out of there with the telestrator, and you saw a classic example of that. When you get two good guys in a trap like that, a nice strong trap, it lets those interceptors, which a dude was in that case, be a lot more aggressive.
Fifi in the corner pulls down Draceline. Martin's got an open look for three.
Well, that's what they needed. They had three assists all by Martin. This time, Martin said, I give it. I'm stunned on take it. And Fifi, dude, does a nice job grabbing that basketball in there. Left Martin wide open. He could have made himself a ham sandwich before he shot that ball, before anybody could have closed out on him.
Martin called for the foul.
You know I know about those ham sandwiches, Barry. Look at that. Plenty of time out there to get that one lined up and knocked down. He made three three-pointers against Arkansas. Pine Bluff, I was not surprised to see him take that ball. He's going to be aggressive tonight, and he has his opportunity.
Sutton in the game for the Mustangs. Inside, McCall pulls back and goes up over the top of Martin.
Oh, that was pretty.
That was pretty, wasn't it?
Nice one dribble, straight up, straight down, jump shot along the baseline. That's not an easy shot to make. Very little depth perception to work with. Wonderful shot by that young man.
Carr, ooh, loses the handle, goes right into McCall's hands. So, just inside the arc, slashing, cutting in the corner. Oh my, Mustangs on fire now. Fields connects for the three.
Yeah, lead change, quick little 5-0 run for the Mustangs, doing it from the outside shots.
Carr. Martin pulls down inside. Quickly, Smith off his fingertips. He's got to pull that ball in. Fields to his left. Irwin comes out, pushing Fields out as Russell. Quickly to the left, McCall. Hit from there before, driving baseline on Martin. Soft one, and it's Goss. Finds its way in.
Yeah, McCall starting to heat up. He's got a nice dribble, pull-up jump shot. He's got 8 points in his game. Doing a nice job along that left baseline.
7-0 run for the Mustangs. Inside, Smith. Oh, he's fouled.
Mark Kerwin can't get that off.
Yeah. Yeah, well, he tries to get it up quickly, but the Cal Poly team is well coached. They've been trained to say, hey, we got a big guy underneath that we can't jump with. Let's foul him, put him on the line, and live with the free throw opportunities. But look at that, McCall. That's the best defender on the Lopes right there. Jared Martin trying to stick McCall. He does a nice job driving him hard, and he puts on the brakes. Martin can't quite stop himself from going backwards. It gives him just enough space to be able to go up and knock out jump shot down. He got a little soft bounce off of that soft iron. Once again, Kerwin Smith missing the front end of that first the two shots.
Russell trying to give him a little coaching tip there.
Did he tell him to hold his follow through? What did he tell him? What was his?
It was a little.
Maybe it was. Hold the follow through there, huh?
A little erratic. You wanted him. It's nice smooth motion.
Yeah, sometimes that's all it takes. Just one of your buddies coming over, give you a pat in the back. Hey, just try this, and you know we're behind you.
Colin Martin again.
They're trying to out. They're trying to work this matchup.
Wow. Driving baseline. Does he do it again? Nope. Rebound, Smith. Gordon at 6'8", big body in for the Mustangs along with McCall in the corner. Carr, cross court. Fifi looking to his right to Russell. Inside, Carr. Ooh, he's sworn. Back out. Fifi. He pulls down, drive baseline up high. Oh, it has to go, but the tap back. No. Smith, they're in. He puts it on the hoop of the arm.
The big fella doing damage underneath. They're working on the glass, and then they're starting to get aggressive, getting a little nasty and chippy underneath there. Kerwin Smith got the bucket to put back. Don't want to see him get tossed out of this one with Vernon in foul trouble. Going to need the big fella to keep attacking that glass. Yeah, you can see him right down here. That first jump doesn't get it, then tried to go back, and who was that? Gordon. Gordon gave him a good little chop across the chest and neck, Garrett. Kerwin Smith took exception to it, but Coach Marley wants none of that. He wants him to keep his head in the game.
Boy. They got right in nose to nose. That was like Happy New Year. Kerwin doesn't back down. Quickly, the officials reacting.
Yeah, it wasn't a whole lot there. I mean, he was trying to give him a hard foul, missed the basketball, missed his arm, and then, you know, chopped him across the
the chest and I don't say the neck, but certainly the upper part of his chest. You see him get missed there and then whack, whack, and then, he did get him up against the head, side of the head. I don't think it was intentional. He was just trying to get to the basketball. And Kerwin Smith didn't like it a whole lot. A young man, let him play basketball, give him a couple techs and play on.
Yep.
I like when the officials do that quickly.
Both teams, right?
Yeah. I like when the officials Gordon's get together, look at it quickly, boom, make a decision, yep. Let's play ball. This is not football. We don't want 3-minute instant replays and trying to assess things from four different camera angles. Take one quick look at it. Make a decision. Everybody's going to have to live with the consequences. Let's play basketball. Once again, that's exactly what the officials did. I'm happy for it. Kerwin Smith got to make this free throw line, make him start paying. They're going to hack him, which they've been doing. They know, like the hack of Shaq, where they used to put Shaquille O'Neal on the free throw line because he was a poor free throw shooter. You just got to make him pay from the line. That's all.
There you go.
That fall through. Whatever Russell told him seems to be working.
Man, the season Russell's having. If he says something, I'd listen,
I agree. Even got his girlfriend to say yes, huh?
Sutler. Driving right, leads from McCall. He's on the right side now, going up high. Too heavy. Pulled down by Carr. Fifi-Adu on the run, slashing it up high off the glass.
Getting some good contributions from their guard, whether it was Shaq Carr a game ago with the 18 points filling in for Adu. Now, Adu coming off the bench here. You got Adu, Russell, and Carr all working together now on the floor. So Coach Marlins decided to go small ball to match Cal Poly small ball.
Lopes, the pendulum swinging back their way. 6-0 run in the last minute, 15. Lopes lead it by 3, 26-23. 3:59 on the clock and counting in the opening half. As the Lopes closing out their homestand, looking for their fourth straight victory. Can they do it? Well, you'll need to keep it right here on CW6.
GCU's College of Science, Engineering, and Technology offers a premier STEM education with relevant curricula designed to lead you to a career in the competitive fields of science, technology, engineering, and math. GCU is investing in the future of our STEM programs with multiple state-of-the-art facilities, providing students with access to cutting-edge technology. Our STEM education is motivated by a Christian worldview, which cultivates ethical decision-making. The College of Science, Engineering, and Technology fosters traits in adaptability, collaboration, creativity, as well as ethical and social awareness, which makes our graduates from our STEM programs more competitive. Through robust collaboration and partnership with industries that require a STEM-prepared workforce, our faculty concentrates exclusively on student success within a deeply nurturing Christian setting. Find out more at gcu.edu/CSET.
Jared Martin having a very steady and consistent shot. You're not the only one. I had a chance to talk to the sophomore guard, and he said he knows he's been struggling a bit with his shot, and it's getting a little frustrating. Although maybe it's coming around. He has had back-to-back season-high 13 points in the last two games. However, Martin said he thinks he needs to go out there and be a little bit more tougher mentally. He said it is getting to him that and kind of messing with his mind a bit that he's been missing that shot that normally comes so naturally. But he said what's keeping his confidence up is the fact that Dan Marley has been very steady in him and giving him that confidence. He's had a green light this whole season to take those good shots. He said despite the fact that sometimes it doesn't fall in his favor, Marley has never said anything except go out there and take that shot once again. And perhaps it's all coming around, but the good news is Martin has not let any other parts of his game go. In fact, he's leading the whack right now when it comes to steals, averaging 1.9 per game. Also on this list of top five, his teammate Dwayne Russell with 1.64 steals per game. As you see in there, Ian Baker of New Mexico State ranks 4 on that list. But Jared Martin, we talked about, guys, you know, maybe it was at home cooked meals with his mom in town for the holidays. Maybe just settling into the groove, but he seems to have found that finesse again with his shot. But he said he's going out there trying not to think about it too much and just let his natural ability take over.
Yeah, it's good to see his game starting to turn.
Vegemite. Probably bottom of a jar of that Vegemite.
I heard that's not really tasty. That's not really good.
Yeah, I think it's an acquired taste. Kind of like tastes like coffee ground spread over toast.
That would probably take a little while to get accustomed to.
Yeah, well, I used to not like coffee. Now I'm dependent on it every morning to get this whole body moving. I just showed you a picture from my freshman year of what wow. I look like.
Is that your New Year's resolution to get down to that weight?
Oh, good. No, I don't think I look good that way. I was thinking I was about 210 pictures after Coach Smith got a hold of me and started running me my freshman year in college. But I wouldn't mind dropping 49 pounds or so. That's got to be my goal, 49 pounds. I'll be 49 in March, so I got a year to do it. I can do it.
You can do it.
I might need fans out there to hold me accountable, though. You too, Barry.
Oh, well,
you and Kate.
I probably
Rich.
Will.
Rich Reed in the truck.
A few people probably will.
Floater by Russell. Too happy. Pulled down by McComb.
You'll be pulling food out of my mouth constantly.
Look, Kerwin Smith came into the game at 6 points, 5 boards, in 8 minutes.
He's been solid off that bench, Coach Marley. Vernon gets in foul trouble, or just replacing Darian Clark. Doing a nice job using his muscle and his length around the basket. He's added 15 pounds. That's where I was going with that story. He's added those 50 pounds of muscle. It's made him feisty.
Abrams got that rebound, but it's picked off by Carr. No CPA new driving, pushes back out Russell. Russell, floater, and it doesn't go.
How in the world did that ball come out?
It was
at least, maybe even two-thirds of the way.
Bounce pass, Abrams, look out.
Ooh, he hits the floor hard again.
Well, I thought maybe there was some contact underneath the officials missed, but he's not complaining about anything.
Fifi driving, back out, threaded the needle. Martin looking for three. Oh, short off the front of the rim. Fields with a rebound.
Russell's got to be more aggressive now. Yeah, he's got a couple quick early baskets, and he's been quiet since. Just 2 minutes to go. And the team seems like it's sputtering here with just 26 points. He needs to be more aggressive. I thought he'd finish this half with at least in double digits, probably closer to 16 points.
Back out Toth to Joseph. Joseph, three-point attempt. Off the mark, Smith with the rebound.
Right, Smith doing a job on that glass. What a man-sized rebound. High with two hands for the ball. Six of them now.
Fifi can't get the handle. Carr. Back to Martin. Quickly to Russell to his right on the near side. Driving baseline up high. Doesn't go, but Kerwin Smith makes sure it does.
Oh, they woke up a beast at Kerwin Smith with all those hard fouls. Is playing like a demon out there, just attacking that basket time and time again.
Mustangs 0 for the last 5 from the field. Their drought is 2-13 and counting. 3-point Lopes lead. Teller fails down in the corner for Joseph. Comes back out. Joseph driving in the paint up high. Fifi got a hand on it and picks it away. Under a minute to go, opening half. Valero wanted to call. Russell driving, stopping, popping, too heavy. Oh, Kerwin couldn't put it back.
That would have been incredible if he had got that tip slam to go right there. I mean, as much as he's been hitting that glass, sometimes you have to go 3 or 4 times to get one. He got back-to-back putbacks. That would have been something to remember.
He called. Mustangs trying to get a bucket here. Approaching over 3 minutes. 8, 7, 6 on the shot clock. Oh, red, red into Fifi. Quickly Fields, 4, 3. What's he gonna do? Floater. Oh, and he put it home. Oh, that's just a backbreaker.
Yeah, several times tonight, the Lopes have played that strong defense, nearly created a turnover, yet the Mustangs escape with a field goal going the other way. This is the time right before that, Fifi do had a poke away that Fields was lucky to get back, and then he kind of stutter stepped on Smith just to freeze the big fella long enough to be able to put it back in drive and go off glass.
Fields playing well, came in the season average 9 points per game. He's got 10 in the opening half.
Back to his defense one more time here. And that's Kerwin Smith and Fifi Adu protecting that basket. That led to the run out the other way. But we've had a number of great defensive performances here by the GCU Lopes in this first half. The problem is, I think on the other end, the Lopes just haven't been able to find the basket as much as they would like, especially their leading scorer, the third leading scorer in the country, Russell, who averages over 25 a game. He got two quick ones, but since then he's 0-for-5 from the field.
16 and counting. Lopes trying to get the bucket at the buzzer. Lead is one. Carr, 10, 9. Fifi in the corner, driving baseline, bounce pass. Martin, 5, looks for 3. And he hits it! No shot. Whoa, Jared Martin at the buzzer.
Well, nice job. They tried the trap. They tried to catch GCU to run them out of whatever half-court set Coach Marlin is playing, but this team is so well coached, they didn't let them phase them. They spread the floor out, then nice ball fake, and then being aggressive. That's why I like Jared Martin.
Let's send it over to Kate.
All right, thank you guys. Well, Coach, you were shooting near 50%, but I imagine for a second half, the game plan has to be to get the ball in Martin's hands more, or to Dwayne to get him. He's 2%.
Well, you're trying. They're just playing a matchup zone, and they're not going to leave him. So we're just going to have the other guys step up. And, you know, Dwayne got some good shots down the stretch, just missed a few of them. So if he gets shots, fine. If he doesn't, the other guy's going to stick up. But he's going to face us all year long. They're just in a matchup zone, and they're going to guard him and not leave him. But we got to get him in transition, and then he's got to finish around the basket. He had a few good looks.
And the good news is, coming off the bench, you're getting that support. Kerwin Smith with 11 minutes already, 8 points, 7 boards. What do you need to see from him and the rest of the bench to continue that play, especially heading into the
bench? Well, I mean, it's Kerwin and Fifi. That's really only the bench. I thought Fifi did a good job. Kerwin just got to be strong. He's got to catch it and not bring it down and finish. I mean, he's got to finish in there, and he's got to hit his free throws. Did a good job on the rebounding. We got to get other guys in there flying in for offensive rebounds.
All right, thank you very much. Looking for another strong second half from this team. As Coach mentioned, trying to get Dwayne Russell going, but this is good practice for what's ahead with the WAC. They know who to target, that's for sure.
Yeah, the two leading scorers for both respective teams. Russell with just 5 points, while Toth has 0. Kate will be back with more of the halftime festivities with the Lopes up by 4, 31-27 here on CW6.
Company's Comfortpedic Inc. We're a local mattress company here. It's a small family business that my dad started. Now we are providing the dorm mattresses to the most recent dorms here at GCU. One of my professors, he was a professor for my junior year, Paul Waterman, he was the one that started everything. Without him, like, this wouldn't have been possible. I came up with a short presentation, a quick business pitch. I present to Dr. Gibb with my company history, and he loved it. So first we started with the hotel mattresses. Brett Courtwhite was very helpful, and everything ran smoothly. From there, we began with the dorm mattresses. We asked them what exactly they were looking for in a dorm mattress, and that's when we started to come up with a prototype. We brought in one of the mattresses that GCU currently has. We opened it up. We saw where they needed improvement and what we could do best to, like, maximize a better prototype, and we came up with the mattresses that we have now, and after that everything ran pretty smoothly, thankfully. You can see the community thriving along with GCU, and just the fact that GCU was willing to buy locally from a company that's only 10 minutes away, you can tell that they really want the community to grow with them. I'm very proud to say I'm a Lope, and I tell it to everyone, like, go to GCU, Lopes up. I'm very, very proud.
With a 31-27 lead over the Mustangs of Cal Poly here at the break. I'm Kate. Kate Longworth. You're watching the Lopes halftime show here on the CW6. And I'm joined now by Councilman Daniel Valenzuela. Thank you so much for being here with us. And it is safety night here. Why is it so important to recognize first responders? And before I even go on, I want to recognize you because you are a Valley firefighter. So thank you for serving. And what's it mean to you on a night like tonight? You're kind of on both sides, celebrating the first responders and also being appreciated.
Well, I think if you were to talk to any of the first responders here tonight, it's something that they're not expecting that type of recognition, but it is nice, it is appreciated. There are a lot of parallels between what we do as first responders and what GCU does. Yeah. It starts with service, and that's what we have in common.
Very deep parallels, Jaw. You're actually very accurate on that, and you know GCU very well, representing District 5, which includes GCU. How important are the first responders in this area?
Well, first responders in this area are very close to this university. This university works very well with the local police precinct, the fire station, which is right down the street. GCU now has its own police department, which is really, you know, it's great to do that. And so it's just been a great partnership with the city of Phoenix, our first responders, and of course this university.
And as GCU continues to grow, what does the presence of the student population here and all that this university does for the community mean to your district?
Well, you know, look, first and foremost, it's about education. We want to educate our youth. But I will tell you, I'll remind you and those watching, in a 4-mile radius around this university, crime rates are down by 30%. Property values are up by 30%. GCU is doing such a great job in partnering with the city of Phoenix and just, again, just moving this entire community forward. It's very exciting for all of us.
Some impressive numbers to be very proud of. So thank you so much for being here tonight. Again, thank you for serving, and thank you for appreciating those others who serve as well.
Go Lopes. Thank you.
All right. As you can see, he is a big Lopes fan. Who isn't, right? Well, so far this season, the Lopes are making fans happy as they try to go for their sixth straight win here at home. The score right now, 31-27. We'll see what they can do second half. Barry and Scott back with us to bring us highlights and more.
GCU is the university that never sleeps, moving at the speed of light. And now GCU is leading in the area of computer science and IT. With over 200 university degree programs across 9 colleges, on campus and online, join the most inventive concept in education today. Fast track options available with courses in cybersecurity, cloud computing, and systems architecture. Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University. Visit gcu.edu/IT. At GCU, earning your degree online doesn't have to be without the college experience. To find your purpose, it takes support from those around you. GCU's leadership offers over 3 decades of experience in delivering real-world degree programs online. GCU's online class size averages less than 17 students with full-time faculty and student advisors. Find your purpose online at Grand Canyon University. Call us today at 855-428-7692.
Finding the right college isn't always simple. The choices I make today affect where I'll be tomorrow. That's why I chose Grand Canyon University. Here I'm working toward a greater purpose and a place that feels like home. With scholarships to help me earn my degree, I can graduate in less than 4 years. By attending GCU, Arizona's premier private Christian university, I know I'm not just making the right choice, I'm making the smart choice.
Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University. Private, Christian, affordable. Visit gcu.edu.
Back on the campus of Grand Canyon University in Phoenix, Arizona, the Lopes leading the Mustangs from Cal Poly 31-27. Barry Vitel alongside Scott Williams. Well, once again, the opponent comes into the GCU Arena, kind of punches the Lopes in the mouth early on. They take the opening lead, and then the Lopes storm back, and now they take a 4-point lead.
It's those zone defense. As Coach Barley hit it on the head going to the break there. They don't practice zone defense, so they don't even get a chance to go against it in practice. So it takes them a while to kind of figure out that riddle, and then once they do, they're off and running. They had a good first half. Almost everybody shot over 50%, except for Dwayne Russell, who's 2 for 7.
Go figure. Kerwin Smith coming in off the bench, looking real sharp. Time for our halftime highlights, brought to you by Hyundai. ShopBuyHyundai.com today. How about Shaq Carr to the hole?
Shaq Carr was really good in the starting lineup there. You know, Shaq attack going to the basket. And I love this one right, Russell. I don't know if that's just being lucky or being good. When things go in your way, they're going your way. And Shipley was good. He was strong to the hole in that first half, knocking down a couple points. He had 4 points in that first half. He was a great job playing good defense for nearly 35 seconds and just got beat out of the corner with the three-point shot there. Then Martin hit a couple threes in that half. I like that one right there because he was ready to fire and he was being aggressive. Fields was wonderful. He knocks down a three-point shot there. He had 10 points in that first half, and I love that one. But that one, McCall really got it going for a while there. Jared Martin had no answer for him defensively. I like that one there by Fifi Adu going strong to the basket, and Smith with the follow-up there, and then he got mixed up. They woke the beast in Kerwin Smith, and he was lights out on both ends of the floor after that. I love this one here. Follow the big man right to the basket. When he goes to try to block the shot, you right there to clean it up. So just a wonderful job, especially on the defensive end right there. That 38% shooting was a great job, great team effort.
Field goal shooting for GCU, 46.2. Who would have thunk it though? Russell, 5 points, and the leading scorer, Toth, for the Cal Poly Mustangs, doesn't have a point in this opening half.
Well, it just lives to show the game plans were to stop those two particular players, and like Coach Marley said, other guys have to step up. I think other guys did step up in that first half, but I look for Russell to bounce back here in that second half and provide some offensive punch.
Probably a good bet. Kate will be back in just a moment with VP of Athletics for Grand Canyon University, Mike Vaughn. So stick around here on CW6.
Our company's Comfortpedic Inc. We're a local mattress company here. It's a small family business that my dad started. Now we are providing the dorm mattresses to the most recent dorms here at GCU. One of my professors, he was a professor for my junior year, Paul Waterman, he was the one that started everything. Without him, like, this wouldn't have been possible. I came up with a short presentation, a quick business pitch. I present to Dr. Gibb with my company history, and he loved it. So first we started with the hotel mattresses. Brett Courtwhite was very helpful, and everything ran smoothly. From there, we began with the dorm mattresses. We asked them what exactly they were looking for in a dorm mattress, and that's when we started to come up with a prototype. We brought in one of the mattresses that GCU currently has. We opened it up. We saw where they needed improvement and what we could do best to, like, maximize a better prototype, and we came up with the mattresses that we have now, and after that, everything ran pretty smoothly, thankfully. You can see the community thriving along with GCU, and just the fact that GCU was willing to buy locally from a company that's only 10 minutes away, you can tell that they really want the community to grow with them. I'm very proud to say I'm a Lope, and I tell it to everyone, like, go to GCU, Lopes up. I'm very, very proud.
Lopes basketball here on the CW6. GCU with a 31-27 lead over Cal Poly Mustangs here at the break. Dan Marley hoping for a strong second half. Only time will tell. But for the meantime, we're going to talk a little bit basketball and GCU athletics. And I'm Kate Longworth, and I am joined now by Vice President of Athletics here at GCU, Mike Vaught. Thanks so much for being here. We always love the updates from your point of view. And one of the things I want to talk about is a strong holiday season here inside the arena. 7 home games for men's basketball.
Yeah.
What has that meant to the student population and also the community? We're seeing a lot of families out here.
Well, first, happy holidays to everybody. You know, it's incredible the culture here and the crowds we have. This crowd tonight's unbelievable. We have no students. So it's been a great December. Home court advantage here is really important to our team and makes the holidays special for all the local fans.
And I know you have a tough job when you're managing all the athletics and you're really trying to get the word out there how strong Lopes basketball is and Lopes across the boards in all sports. But it must make your job easy when you go up against powerhouses like Louisville and Duke and Arizona, and all they can do is talk about GCU.
Well, it's good. It's great for our university, and we wanted to step out this year and play some top 20 teams. It's the year to do it. We want to get our brand out nationally for our university.
It will get us ready for postseason play next year, and it also helps recruiting student athletes and students getting the exposure nationally. So it's been great. Dan and the team did a great job. As you know, we played some really good programs. I think a lot of people around the country know a little more about GCU now.
That's for sure. It's been the talk not only of the town but of the nation. Also, the talk of the town is the growth here on campus. Tell me a little bit of where we're at with the 10 sports facilities in 2 years. Where are you at right now?
Well, softball is under construction now. The competition part of the facility will be done in February. We'll put temporary bleachers in for the season and then come back and do the stadium. And then after the baseball season ends, we'll start the baseball stadium. It'll be ready for next year. Beach volleyball just was completed last week, so the sound of construction is still happening here at GCU.
Hey, but it's faster than it is anywhere else in the Valley, yeah, so we're doing something right. Well, thank you so much for joining us here. So all best things in 2017.
Happy New Year.
Yeah, same to you. Meanwhile, Dan Marley hoping his team gets a Happy New Year present right here at home. 31-27, more game action coming your way right after this.
Our company's Comfortpedic Inc. We're a local mattress company here. It's a small family business that my dad started. Now we are providing the dorm mattresses to the most recent dorms here at GCU. One of my professors, he was a professor for my junior year, Paul Waterman, he was the one that started everything. Without him, like, this wouldn't have been possible. I came up with a short presentation, a very quick business pitch. I present to Dr. Gibb with my company history, and he loved it. So first we started with the hotel mattresses. Brett Courtwhite was very helpful, and everything ran smoothly. From there, we began with the dorm mattresses. We asked them what exactly they were looking for in a dorm mattress, and that's when we started to come up with a prototype. We brought in one of the mattresses that GCU currently has. We opened it up. We saw where they needed improvement and what we could do best to, like, maximize a better prototype, and we came up with the mattresses that we have now, and after that everything ran pretty smoothly, thankfully. You can see the community thriving along with GCU, and just the fact that GCU was willing to buy locally from a company that's only 10 minutes away, you can tell that they really want the community to grow with them. I'm very proud to say I'm a Lope, and I tell it to everyone, like, go to GCU, Lopes up. I'm very, very proud.
Just underway at GCU Arena, Lopes in possession. Carr stopping and popping quickly. Wow, that was a lot quicker than the opening half, but I mean, the fans take a seat.
Well, it warmed up now. They figured out how to find their shots and their comfort spots on the floor.
Jones looking for his first point. Got it by Freyer. Deontay came out. Donovan Field trying to do his right, pushing Russell back, high off the glass. Rebound is pulled down by Russell. Russell in the corner, Jared Martin, short. Shipley with the rebound.
Just to me, looked like Martin didn't have a good base on that shot. His feet looked very close together. When you're pushing that three-pointer, you want to make sure you have a good foundation in which to use, engage your lower half of your body. Martin's got to spread those biscuits out a bit more.
Shipley back out. Come. Stopping just inside the arc. Rebound is pulled down by Gordon, and he's fouled. Vernon.
Gordon did some work early that time on Vernon, got him in a bad way, and just worked quicker to that rebound. And fortunately for Vernon, who had the two early fouls in the first half, picks up a quick third one here in the second half.
Gordon at the line, 64% coming in. Linwood, Washington native connects. Lead is 4 for GCU. Carr high by Fields, backs up. Russell, Martin, top of the key, over to Freyer. He'll come back out inside. Oh, bounce pass off the feet of Gordon.
That's Martin being unselfish, but if you remember from that first half, that pass was very effective going inside to Freyer, who was able to spin in that key and find an easy 14-foot jump shot. That's one I'd like to see Martin work on for next year.
Stopping, popping, it's away, Russell.
Now the guards have been were good early in that first half. And here again, you see Shaq, Carr, and Russell with back-to-back baskets pushing that lead up to 6 points now.
Fields to his left, Shipley. Shipley eyed by Carr. Shipley trying to find some room. Moves to his left, by his baseline again underneath the bucket. 10 on the shot clock. Vernon's on him. Driving to his right. Vernon knocked the ball out from behind.
Well, that was risky by Vernon. Carrying those three fouls with him. But look at this one by Vernon. He put the bigger defender on those roller skates, pushing strong to the basket. And he's just quick to pull up, creating that space for his jump shot.
McCall working on Martin. Dropped back, and he hits it again at the buzzer.
Oh, McCall has gotten the better of Martin three particular times in this first half with that stepping backward, fadeaway type motion. And Martin's just kind of shaking his hand, rinsing his hands, like, what more can I do? I'm playing good defense. Kids just beat me with better shots. So sometimes you just got to pat him on the back and say, I'll see you next time down the floor. Try to even this thing up.
Call with 10. He's averaging 8.8 coming in. Russell, 4-3. Better get it off. Martin's underneath quickly. Carr! Oh, not there. Rebound underneath.
A shot clock violation because the shot was off. However, the ball never hit the rim to reset the shot clock. But I like that drive by Martin. But you're a little bigger than Shaq Carr in there. Go ahead and try to either dunk that thing or get that body contact where you can go to line and knock down a couple freebies.
Ripley, the little water bug all over the place. Back out, Fields. Field driving on Russell.
Russell's laughing because I think he's thinking, this is the first time I'm actually looking over the top of a defender's head when I'm playing defense. Normally it's the other way, and these little smaller point guards out of the floor going back and forth at each other with the dribble penetration.
Told to Shipley. Shipley, dribble handoff. Boy, the scouting report's good. Saw that all during shoot around. The Lopes defending that. Back out. Gordon pulls down. Shipley looking for three. Off the mark to the left. Big rebound. McCall battling after. Bounce pass. Loose ball. Oh, Gordon's there, and Martin reaching in.
That's the rough one by Martin. There were two guys going for the ball up in the air. I think there was four hands on the ball at one point, but it's Martin's lower body that takes out Gordon underneath, and maybe that's what they get the whistle for.
McCall with a quick inbound, nothing but net.
Good green. McCall is feeling it tonight, I would say. Hot early in that first half, and now getting himself going here in the first 4 minutes of this second period.
12 for Luke McCall. 2-point Lopes lead. Russell and Martin playing catch. Quickly inside, Carr back out. Russell pulls down. Oh, draws the foul. He took a bit of it. Oh, my. The right shoulder looks like he's in pain. Oh, no, 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 no. No, no, no.
I think he had that pump fake and then jumped up into the defender, and either a knee or an elbow got him on the shoulder. But you're right, he is favoring that right shoulder, and not feeling real good right now. He's a tough guy.
Oh, he's all right. Where the collective wind came out of everybody, didn't it?
Yeah, he's been everything to this team. You can see it again there. Yeah, look like that left knee comes right across the shoulder and back area of Russell. He's feeling it. That's gonna have to ice that one down after this ball game. That's a shooting arm too, you know. Don't want anything to happen to that golden arm. He's been fantastic this year. We talked about him third in the country, knocking down 25 points a game.
Crowd knows how valuable he is, getting a bit of a round of applause.
Yeah, well, you know, it's one thing to stay in the game, and you know, can he be effective? Now let's see if anything changes on his motion from the line. Looked pretty good there.
How many does he have here? Shooting from that arc, wasn't he?
I thought he had dipped in just in front of that arc. So I think, yeah, they gave him two shots.
Drop both of them. Gordon looking, surveying. Little handoff, Shipley. He'll do the same to Toth. Shipley. Back out. Oh, look, call. Look out. Fields. Fields trying to get around. Giante comes out. Too heavy. Rebound. Russell. Shaq Carr. Up off the glass and in for Shaq Carr.
Oh, I like that Shaq Carr took that to the basket. I thought for a minute he might try to hand off, high handoff to Vernon, who was on that weak side.
McCall again. Oh, my goodness. Look, McCall having to give himself a game.
Yeah, they may have to change the defensive strategy here now for McCall because he's got it stuck in automatic.
Russell around in the corner now to Frayer. Oh, in and out. McCall with the rebound.
It's like these GCU shooters have had a couple dip down below that rim only to spin out.
Pauly to bring in a couple of players at the scorer's table. Shipley bounce pass. Gordon all alone. High off the glass. Doesn't go.
I shot that a little flat. I think Gordon, maybe he's trying to aim that ball a bit much and didn't put the necessary arc on it to give himself the benefit of the iron there.
Inside Keontae Barrett.
Beautiful high-low pass. Jared Martin finding Vernon after the high set and roll to the basket.
Five assists for Jared Martin. Shipley comes out, takes it from Fields. Up high, look, oh my goodness, looky here, looky, looky.
Zach Gordon can't believe it. He missed the little bunny just a moment ago, and this one he thinks, okay, I got myself a dunk, but the ball gets wedged between the backboard and the rim. I think that's going to be possession. That'll be possession to the Mustangs underneath.
All right, 41-36 is the score. Let's send it over to Kate.
Well, how do you top an ending like that? Well, I'm going to try with men's volleyball coach Matt Burley joining me. The season starts on January 6th. How are you guys looking for the upcoming season?
You know, we just got off our first day of our preseason practice today, and there's a very, very electric buzz in our gym. You know, we have 22 guys on our roster, 10 new faces, and we're excited to get going.
I want to get to know this roster because I really think that we need to be broadcasting some of these matches. Most specifically, that trip to Hawaii on January 11th. Pretty great schedule for that. And what are you anticipating just a trip like that? How will it be a bonding experience for your guys?
You know, this will be, we're returning again this coming year. We were there last year. The environment in that gym is just like none other in the country. You know, 3,000-4,000 fans in there that love the sport, but we also have three Hawaiians on our roster. So we're very well supported and treated very much at home when we're there.
Well, that's great because you get the experience too, I'm sure, when you're there. And then I know you're looking at the schedule as a whole, but I imagine when you look at February 24th and 26th with the defending champion Ohio State Buckeyes coming to town, what's that mean to this program?
You know, they're in our conference, so we've actually seen them year in, year out. But Friday night's going to be exciting because we're going to be in this arena, you know, hopefully with a packed house. Ohio State's returning every single starter in their lineup, so it's going to be a tall order. But, you know, our guys are excited for the challenge, and, you know, we're working one day at a time right now.
You talked about that roster, 22. Who are some of the returnees, and who should we keep an eye on?
You know, we have an outside, Shalev Sada, who's returning for us. He's coming off some surgeries over the summer, but he's putting his time in. He's really dedicated to our program. Our libero is going to be very, very good again for us this year. We have about four or five guys returning that we're really excited about.
All right, well, we wish you the best of luck. Thanks so much for joining us. And guys, we got to work on that Hawaii trip, January 11th. I'll clear my schedule. You ready?
Yeah, we tried to go with the women's basketball team, and they wouldn't take us. Now we're working on Matt Worley.
Good to grass skirt, too. That's their loss.
Now, see, that in itself would probably...
No? You won't do it for
him. See, now I can't block the visual. The whole second half.
Can't even see that, huh?
No. Second half shooting, GCU at 57%. Cal Poly at 33%. On the Lopes bench, outscoring the Mustangs 10-5. Lead is 5. Carr to Russell. Russell just inside the arc. Oh, short.
Yeah, he had the direction, just didn't have the distance on that one.
Shipley. Good call again on Martin. Busting his way, trying to do the left hand, not there. Possession, Lopes, as it went out of bounds.
Yeah, this guy, he's trying to get it any way he can from out there behind the arc, driving to the basket, mid-range game, and that time tried to go for the little lefty jump hook. He had 19 points at Irvine earlier this year for a career high. He's trying to top that tonight.
He comes out, takes a seat as Coach Calero brings out the hot shooter. Russell in the corner from Derek Martin, back to Carr. 10 on the shot clock, just inside the arc. Hits the front of the rim, rebound is pulled down by Nijo. Joseph, on the left wing. Joseph back out. Travel on Joseph.
Well, it was good defense by the Lopes. Joseph got up in the air and was trying to find someone to pass to. Fortunately, came down before he got the ball out of his hands. The officials right on top of it whistled him for the violation.
Quickly, Carr to the right. Fifi Adu, baseline. Cross court. Martin looks for three. Oh, front of the rim. Rebound pulled down by Abrams.
A nice cross court pass that time by Adu, finding Martin behind the arc. He's already knocked out a couple threes.
Shaq Carr picks it off, loses the handles, fouled by Joseph.
Well, the transition game for the Lopes after they get turnovers has been strong all season long, and I like this one by Shaq Carr because he just guessed that I'm going to get over on that left hand and try to swipe this basketball away, and it was a good guess because Kerwood Smith, whose rim protector was trailing the play, so had he missed, it would have been an easy layup. But he's very crafty at getting those turnovers in the midcourt.
Carr, near side, comes back out front. Martin, Russell, up by Nijo, moving to his right, floater up high, and he drops it, and he gets the foul. Hoop and a hard.
Nice job that time by Russell, gets himself into double figures and scoring there. He's been very good at that little float game, as he likes to call it, that area between the front of the rim and the below the free throw line, and floating that thing up over the top.
43-36 is the score. The Lopes on top, just a tick under 12 to go in the second half.
I'm Dominique. I'm a student here at Grand Canyon University studying hospitality management. My hospitality courses here are giving me a high quality education from professors that I know have been successful. Being able to work while I'm in school has enriched my college experience. I feel like I know where I'm going and what I want to do. I've gone through things that can't necessarily be taught, and so that paired with everything that GCU is doing for me, I feel like, you know, is setting me up for success. To have someone say, like, I want you, that's like a lot for someone like me. They're changing people's lives. By changing my life, now you changed my little brothers and sisters because they saw that I went to college. It'll just be, you know, my greatest accomplishment, not just because it's a diploma, but because, you know, I did what no one really thought I could do. When they say find your purpose, they mean it.
Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University. Private, Christian, affordable. Visit gcu.edu.
Welcome back. You're watching Lopes basketball here on the CW6. The Lopes climbing out to a lead to start the second half. They're up 43-36 right now. 11 of those points belong to Zero the Hero. And really, are we surprised when you look at these numbers? Dwayne Russell leading the way in the WAC with minutes played, averaging 37.8 minutes. He's also first in conference action when it comes to points per game with 25.2. Second in the WAC from three from beyond the arc with a 48.1% shooting. He's fifth in the WAC, we've talked about, with steals and assists. He's second, 4.9 averaging per game. Really, is there anything this guy cannot do? He's leading the way for the Lopes. We've seen that. But when he's leading the way for the conference and also the nation when it comes to scoring, he's third on that list. Got to be impressed with what Zero the Hero is doing. And Scott, maybe from your perspective, when you're a player, and you think for a time last year it could be over, and then you get to come back and get this kind of year of just getting that free bonus time to play, he's really making the most of it.
Oh, he certainly has, Kate. He's done a wonderful job stepping in when Josh Bond went down, because remember, this guy wasn't the scorer that he was a year ago. He scored a few points, but mostly he was an assist dude. Now he says, this is my time to try to lift my team and elevate my play. And he's certainly done a wonderful job, but still a leader. Doesn't come across as a ball hog. He's come across as a guy that still wants to put the team first.
Toth with his first bucket of the game.
Yeah, welcome to the party, pal. Hey, this is the leading scorer. He's finally getting his first bucket, 11:35 mark in this game. Let me ask the question, Barry. You think we have a 5-point game with 11:30 to go in this one?
No. Nope.
Give these Mustangs a lot of credit.
5-point lead. Toth gets his first bucket. He leads the team in scoring.
Coming off the holidays and looking forward to New Year's Eve plans. And you wonder if the Lopes might have looked past this Cal Poly bunch.
Oh my, that was just a nasty turn of events for Jared Martin. Lost the handle. Joseph took it back, and then Martin called for the foul. Third on Jared.
Yeah, and you don't see this happen to Jared Martin very often, but it was Martin and Adu kind of together with the basketball, and that's why he didn't get it cleanly. I think Adu got a hand or a thumb or something on it that just kept Martin from being able to squeeze that ball, and it squirted right back over here to Joseph.
71% free throw shooter Victor Joseph coming into the game. 3-point lead for GCU. All right, by Joseph. To his right. Carr looks inside. Kerwin Smith up over. Abrams doesn't drop. Toth with the rebound up for Joseph.
It was a nice strong move by Smith. Might have rushed it just a hair. Could have taken a bit more time. Gathered, trying to go up a little bit smoother underneath.
Well, talk about smooth. Donovan Fields off the glass.
Well, Fields doing a nice job now. He's in double figures. Give him 12 points, a couple boards. A 6-0 run now for the Cal Poly Mustangs to cut this to a 1-point game.
Fifi driving. Foul is called underneath. Abrams.
Look at the arms on Fifi Adu. I think it gives him a lot of confidence to be able to go against taller players underneath. And he's got good athletic ability as well. Gets strong up off the floor. Just hangs long enough to get that lower body contact underneath. Get that foul and go to the line where he's a good free throw shooter.
Adu connects 82% coming in. Freyer in the game, Keontae Vernon in the game, Kerwin Smith and Shaq Carr back to the bench. Ooh, off the mark. Fields to his right. Joseph driving on Fifi. Fifi got that right hand in there.
Hey, you got a little Fields, little Joseph. They kind of put their heads down and just use that speed that they have against defenders, and they get into that body there, and the dude had to wrap them up, not let them get to the lane and get an easy layup.
First on Fifi.
Like a little 1-4 flat here, letting Fields work at the high screen roll situation.
Vernon came out. Oh, Martin got a hand on it. Fifi dive after it.
Oh my.
Oh, Joseph. They collide. Looks like Joseph's okay.
No, he went down like a ton of bricks, but popped right up off the floor. He's tough. Look at this one right here. Adu goes up and just gets that. But this is the strength of Adu and the light feathers there of Joseph. He took a hard tumble down to the floor, but he's up, and coach just wants to make sure he's okay.
Fourth on Joseph, the Rancho Cucamonga native. Russell. Oh, good pick. And a turnover. Shipley driving. High off the glass with the right hand.
Oh my. Blocked shot leads to a run out.
We're not at 44.
Fifi quickly back up. Back out to Russell. Martin slashing in. Back to Fifi. Open look for three. Oh, too heavy. Out of bounds. Mustangs ball. Off of Freya.
Yeah, man. Just the way this game has gone, he did Freya's. Been quiet here in the second half. Vernon's not been able to get the offensive rebound and putbacks and do damage on the offensive end that sometimes he's able to do. And this smaller Cal Poly team now, they realize, hey, we got an opportunity to steal one on the road.
GC only with four offensive rebounds in the game to this point. Field, don't travel.
Easy call for the official. But look at this one here. This is a good block. Fields doesn't give up on the play, even though he was beat. It goes right over to Shipley, and then he gets very creative. You maybe use that left arm just a bit to clear out Mark. Mark certainly didn't want to pick up his fourth personal foul.
Freyer turning the inbound field. Bob Bernadette taps it back. Oh, they needed that bucket.
Yeah, the two guys I talked about that just be kind of invisible on offense. Now Freyer gets to that spot on the floor that he liked and got it up there soft enough where Vernon was able to follow it up.
Stopped a 3.5 minute drop for GCU. Fields pulling back. Looking to his left. Nijo back out. Tuttle. Their leading scorer. Long three. Front of the rim. Rebound. Ah, Abrams pulled it up. Back out front, left hand, and in. Toth cutting his way in.
Got caught ball watching the action underneath, and Toth was smart, saw his defender with his head turn, just went right to the basket.
Got it at 46, 7:40 and counting. Freya, Russell, Shipley on him like glue. Slashing in. Oh, doing Russell. Extra down on that up.
Yeah, Russell's starting to heat up a little bit, realizing this thing's getting tight, and I got some guys that aren't making the shots I need them to make. I better start calling my own number some more.
Toth just inside the arc. Too heavy, but Abrams, the big boy, pulls down the rebound. Fields, 8 rebounds. Lopes a little flat-footed under the bucket. Martin comes out, puts some heat on Shipley with Fifi Adu. Kick back out, Fields pulls down, Russell's on him. Got that left hand on him. Vernon reaches up over the top and picks it off.
No, they're showing that pass, says Vernon.
Fifi Adu, 3-point attempt. Oh, off the rim. Nijo with the rebound.
Lopes with 3 of 6, 3-point shooting in that first half, but haven't been able to get some of the good looks to fall here in the second half.
Nijo, Toth pulls down. Beyond the arc by Martin. 5-4 on the shot clock. Pulls down just inside the. Oh, man, they like to suck that shot clock up.
And Martin, several times now, has had a hand in the defender's face, and yet the step back jumper continues to fall over the top of his outstretched hand. Once knotted at 44 again, now knotted again at 48.
6 points for Toth in the second. Russell does it go.
Timely offensive rebound, putbacks by both Vernon and Martin. The front court player is doing a good job.
Nijo looking to kick out to Fields. Fields driving baseline. Oh, tippy toe along that baseline. Toes, look at him weave. Slapped away by Martin. Oh, I can't believe it. Can't believe it.
Martin's going to walk that one off. He thought he had a good block. You can see Freyer's gone flying out there, running him off that three-point line, and that looked like a pretty good block. I know there was a little kick out with the leg, but I don't think that was enough to warrant a foul call.
8 points in the game for Jared Martin, unfortunately picking up his fourth personal foul, but would you like to see when things aren't connecting for Jared, he just keeps plugging away, does not hesitate.
No, he's a fighter, he's a grinder, and he missed a couple of 3-point shots, but going inside, getting that tip in was huge. And
I like the moxie in which this guy plays. When he plays unselfish, he thinks defense first, he thinks team first, and that's why Coach Marley likes having him on the floor. He went 40 minutes against Arkansas Pine Bluff because he's an extension of that coaching staff, doing the little things, just the ball movement and getting early three assists in this basketball game. I like that one right there. You show the pump fake and you get one in, and then work yourself from the outside in back to the basket. When someone drives to the hole, you get yourself a little easy putback. But just the smartest player out there on the floor at times, most times that is, for GCU.
Send it over to Kate Longworth.
Well, guys, the Mustangs coaching staff has had their eye on Deonte Vernon for years now. They were actually the first school to recruit him when he was a high school player. They also gave him his first offer for a college scholarship. Keontae said he loved every visit he paid to Cal Poly. He said nothing about the program was disappointing. And before today's game, each coach came up to him congratulating him on the great year he's having. Keontae told me, really, there were no marks against Cal Poly, except, well, it was a little too close to home for the California resident. And he wanted to experience a little bit of a broader area. Wanted to be close to home, but not that close to home. However, it was great to see just the Mustangs program coming over, really still following Keontae in his career, showing respect for him and where he's at now. So I know this is a special game for him to now go up against that coaching staff in this program.
Says a lot about their coaching staff. Extend that greeting to Keontae Vernon.
Yeah, classy move, no doubt about it. Jared Martin with those four personal fouls and 5:30 to play. Coach Marley rolling some big dice that he can stay in this basketball game and not foul going down the stretch, because you know you're going to need him in the final minutes of this one, the way this is being played out.
Wow, Toth misses the front end. He's 86% free throw shooter. Lopes have gone cold from the arc here in the second half. 0 for 5.
It has not been Kyle's night tonight.
Under 5.5 to go. GCU holding on to a 1-point lead. Carr right at the free throw line. Oh!
Scribing that one high above the rim and slamming it back through. Nice job by that young man. Setting a nice high pick and then rolling to the basket.
5 minutes and counting, 52-49. McCall on the game again. Oh, look out, look, McCall.
And who'd they go after? The guy with four personal fouls on him. Good coaching over there saying, no, he don't want a foul. Let's go right at him, see if we can't get a bucket.
Paul's career high 19 at Irvine this year. He's got 17 tonight.
Well, foul off the ball that time. I think it was Abrams getting mixed up with Keontae Vernon. They're calling this a one, yeah, one and one. And Lopes are in the bonus.
Can't say anything?
Not a word. Okay. We get quiet with the rest of the fans in here.
Oh.
I wonder sometimes when I'm talking, when they're at the free throw line, these fans are so smart, it gets so quiet. I wonder if the players can hear me.
Yeah.
I want to whisper, but I also want to be able to, the fans watching on TV to be able to hear me talking. So it's kind of a double-edged sword, but couldn't get the second one to drop. Frere almost got an offensive rebound.
I know some of the fans at home want me to be quiet.
you run this show, man.
Toth. Lopes have missed 7 at the line. Lead is 2. Joseph kicked back out. Shipley. He's all over the court. Toth looking to move on Martin. No room. Shipley looking for 3 at the buzzer. Ball in and out. I thought it was going to go. It's been their night. Oh, Vernon got it. Shot to the face. Shipley picks that one off. Intended for Frayer.
Russell's just too far of a pass across court like that. Plenty of time for that ball to be intercepted.
Under 4 to go. Shipley. Oh, looky, looky.
Oh, he got an offensive foul down on the block on Shipley. Keontae Vernon. At first, a little concern might have been Verna down there fighting too hard on the block, but Shipley gets whistled. Costly turnover.
Looks like this one's going to go down to the buzzer. Lopes lead by two over the Mustangs from Calipari. Don't touch that dial. Lock it in on CW6.
At GCU, earning your degree online doesn't have to be without the college experience. To find your purpose, it takes support from those around you. GCU's leadership offers over 3 decades of experience in delivering real-world degree programs online. GCU's online class size averages less than 17 students with full-time faculty. Find your purpose online at Grand Canyon University. Call us today at 855-428-7692.
Hey Phoenix, it's Thunder Dan Marley, head coach at Grand Canyon University. Coming to GCU was a great move for me. Join Antelope Nation by enrolling as an evening student at our beautiful campus in the heart of Phoenix. Earn your bachelor's, master's, or doctoral degree to take your career to the next level. Engage with industry expert instructors in small classroom settings where you can get the support you need to excel. Scholarships available. See you on campus. Go Lopes.
Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University. Visit gcu.edu/evening.
Welcome back. It is a crazy and loud GCU Arena right now. It's only a 2-point game with under 4 minutes to go. I'm Kate Walker. We'll see how this game finishes out, but this is the final game of the 2016 calendar year here at GCU Arena. So I had a chance to talk to some of the players about their New Year's resolutions, and Mayor Josh Braun had a very politically correct answer to this one. Also a very admirable one. He said he doesn't really believe in New Year's resolutions. He just tries to each and every day better himself. Meanwhile, Keontae Vernon said his goal is to be a better person and build a stronger relationship with God. And Jared Martin made his resolution all about the game. He said most specifically he needs to go out there and start making those jump shots. Now, Braun did joke that maybe his resolution should be not to head to any of the mainstream gyms for the next couple of months, because he said it can get a little hard when you have that riffraff in there, you know, those people who don't normally go to the gym, but they make their New Year's resolutions to start working out. So he said he might wait till February to return. That's not a bad tip. And as for me, my New Year's resolution is to be more organized. But I swear I say that every year. How about you guys?
I wonder who he's talking about there. He's going into the gym on the riffraff, trying to drop 49 LBs.
Yeah, I'll be back there. Come on, man. I'll be pumping and sweating.
Come on, man. Freyer to Russell. Russell crossing up over Toll. Oh! Dwayne Russell!
I don't know what that play was, or whether it was just Russell clear out.
Joseph! Underneath McCall, look what has hand delivered to him right under the bucket.
I can't let that ball get below the free throw line when you're trying to fight off a team trying to battle back on you. You get a good bucket at one end, and then they get a quick score at the hoop on the other end. Got to play better defense, get back in transition.
Vernon, turn around, nice feed from Jared Martin.
Jared Martin's been money passing out of that high post area.
Under 3 minutes to go. Ooh, Shipley almost lost the handle. McCall's tied his career high with 19. Timeout by the Mustangs. Marley fired up, bringing his crew over. 2:50 on the clock. Vernon with 9 points in the second half.
Vernon's been big, especially down the stretch here in the second half. I love this one right here because he goes down there and just uses that big backside, sealing underneath and going the little jump hook and throwing that little hook right over the top. You get a high percentage shot there in a 2-point game, and you got it. Money earner Mount Vernon, big underneath.
Lopes trying to improve to 9-5 overall, 7-2 on their home court. Boy, fans, the excitement here, family-friendly entertainment. Be sure to get your GCU men's basketball tickets right now. Season single-game tickets on sale. The WAC season right around the corner, featuring games starting January 7th against Utah Valley. Prime matchups with New Mexico State, Seattle University, CSU Bakersfield, all on the upcoming schedule. And remember, the GCU Arena is a great place to bring the entire family. Reserve your tickets now by contacting the GCU box office at 602-639-8979 or by going
to LopesTickets.com. Let's take a look at the upcoming schedule. We'll close out the 2016 slate at UC Riverside, another Big West Conference opponent. Tune in to 9:10 a.m. with Michael Potter and Tom Kuiper. Then back here as the Western Athletic Conference gets underway against your buddy Mark Bolt and the Wolverines from Utah Valley. And looky here at New Mexico State on the 12th. UTRGV, a couple of road games.
That's going to be a big one. Yeah, I think the one back here at home against Utah Valley.
Yeah.
You mentioned Mark Pope. He's got his team playing real well. Will coach, real smart guy. They'll be well scouted. Lopes will have to be ready for that one. But I don't want to say that the league championship's going to come down to that game at New Mexico State, but I just got a funny feeling that it could possibly be between the Lopes and New Mexico State. And hopefully the Lopes will be healthy enough to go on the road and get a dub.
Yeah, hopefully Josh Braun will be back. Darian Clark will be back. They start a conference play with Coach Weir taking over for Coach Menzies at New Mexico State, doing a great job. McCall looking for a career high, doesn't drop.
That's good defense there, that young freshman. Very smart. He didn't try to block the shot. Just say, let me just stay on the floor, make it a difficult shot.
You're 2.5 to go, Russ. Oh, looking.
I think they're intentionally fouling Vernon underneath to put him on the foul line. Call me crazy, but there's been a couple times now away from the basketball. I hadn't really been watching it play, but they've been fouling Vernon as he's been cutting across that middle and making sure he's the one that has to go to the foul line.
Coach Calera, doesn't look like that was his plan. Oh, goodness. Apparently it worked on that attempt.
Well, the one it was, it'll work. But now he loads to shoot two shots the remainder of the game. So wonder if that strategy will continue.
Yes, by Toles, pulled down by Carr.
Shaq Carr getting back out from that wing spot, getting that rebound.
Careful, Toles almost picked that off. Under 2 minutes to go.
Marley's got it drawn up here. Let's see what he got drawn up. He wanted Shaq Carr on that left side of the floor with the ball.
Carr in and out, back to Russell. 8 on the shot clock, got a move quickly. Ooh, fouled on the play by Joseph.
Yeah, Joseph.
Oh, no, Abrams.
Abrams didn't like the call, but it was clear that he got him trying to recover kind of on the elbow wrist area as he was swiping for that basketball. And Russell at the line for 2 big free throws.
It was on Joseph. That's 5 for him. He's got to take a seat.
Wasn't his night tonight. Yeah, got a couple free throws, and that was really about it out of Joseph.
Good time buckets here.
You can almost give Joseph a pass, though. I mean, you're trying to guard top 3 scorer in the country, your offensive game's going to slip. I got to give him credit because defensively is where he made his mark on this game tonight, and slowing down Dwayne Russell.
Ask Coach Pitino and the Louisville Cardinal about trying to guard Dwayne Russell. There's about 3 or 4 guys, including Quentin Snyder.
He busted them for 43 points, didn't he?
Pulled down, McCall just can't hit that career mark. Oh, wrap around there, foul, Shipley.
A lot of time left to go in this game. Minute and 30 to play, you're only down 6. It's a 2-possession game. You're going to send him to the line 75 feet away from the basket for 2 free throws. It's not even the one-on-one situation. They're in the double bonus. The Lopes have shooting 2 free throws and sending a pretty good free throw shooter to the line. I'll be a younger player, and sometimes pressure burst pipes with younger players, but certainly not the play that you want with a minute 32 to go. Try to play solid defense and create a turnover.
3 personal fouls on Shipley. Timeout by the Mustangs. Coach Calario, 8th season as head coach. Coming off a 77-61 loss at Washington on the 20th. They're at Princeton on Saturday. Women's basketball, the Lopes, well, they're in Hawaii right now. But they'll be back Wednesday, January 4th, 7 p.m. against Arizona Christian. A well-deserved working vacation to Hawaii. No one ever brings us there to take on the University of Hawaii tomorrow. Chaminade on the 31st. Back to reality. Yeah, back to the mainland to take on the Firestorm. The Firestorm average about 70 points per game with three players in double figures. GCU counters with guard Jessica Juski, fresh off a 31-point game against NAU on the 19th. Game time 7 p.m. right here at the arena.
We're going to get a look at Jess this year. She slowed by injury the first part of the year, and now is coming on strong.
Another find from Australia. Team's playing really well. Healthy August Tushard and Casey Rarick. Marina Laramie. Oh, goodness gracious.
Wait a minute, is that count as 2 points or one?
Goodness gracious.
I think they're called goaltending. But it would be curious if it wasn't goaltending. He ended up tipping it into the basket. Maybe it should have counted as 2 points. They're only going to give him the one. Play on. 6-0 run by the Lopes.
Ah, that's a first for me. Ooh, Shipley. Slips, looking to drive. Good work by Rick Shipley. Mustangs call another timeout with 1:19 to go. The lead is 6.
Let's look at this one more time from the line here. This is an interesting one. It was cut, hung up on that rim there, and then, oh yeah, certainly in the cylinder. He can't believe he knocked it. He knocked the ball while it was on the cylinder. I wonder if he's played some international competition where that's actually a legal play. You can knock the ball off the cylinder.
He's from Newberry Park, California.
Yeah. Maybe he's got dual passport we don't know about.
He obviously is upset with himself. Alex Abrams.
Yeah, you have a 50-50 chance that ball was coming off the rim. I'm not sure, 100% sure it was not going to go in anyway. So
yeah,
we'll give him a pass.
I'm sure it was going to drop. Well, it's a nail biter. Back and forth. Coach Calero calls yet another timeout, allowing Coach Marley to draw the play.
Well, if you're thinking at this point that you want to go for three, you got to probably watch Toth. He's a 52% shooter from behind the arc. And they've had a couple guys that have made a few shots tonight. But a lot of time left in this one.
Martin inbound, 1:19 on the clock. Running down the baseline. Bounce pass, Russell. Oh, look out, trying to bust through this press. Foul is called. Nijo.
Foul called on the Mustangs, number 35, Nijo. Second personal.
Lero can't believe the call, but Russell to the line. Ooh.
Oh my goodness. How many games have you seen lost
right
because people have not salted them away from the free throw line? Yeah, possibly. He took that nasty blow on that right shoulder. Just
above. Whoa, 10 missed free throws by the Lopes. Hope that's not a storyline. Coach Marley rubbing his forehead.
He had the guy on the line that you would have wanted to have at the line.
Fields takes it. Man, that was an open lane parting to the Red Sea.
You miss free throws and you give up layups. Two bad combinations.
4-point Lopes lead. Russell's going back.
Yeah, the smaller the lead, the more pressure on each one of these free throw attempts by Russell. 6-point lead. He missed two last time. Now you're down to a 4-point lead. You gotta forget about that last trip to the line and make sure you get two here.
That's more like it.
Yeah, we're not used to seeing number zero. Is zero a number? Number zero?
Yes,
yeah, we're not missing zero going to the line and coming up with zero free throws. It's nice that he's able to go to the line to get two on that one.
All right, nice cushion here, 63-57. Shipley driving.
Oh my.
Hits the bucket.
What a
look out. Here comes the press.
Shipley.
It's to Russell again. Tried to bust through. He's fouled. At least they're getting the ball in the right player's hands.
They are, but they are letting the Mustangs score so quickly at the other end after made free throws.
Where's your defense? Get some guys back to stop them from getting layups. It's one thing if they're knocking in outside shots, but to give a point blank shots at the rim, you might be better off fouling them than giving them layups with only 5 or 6 seconds coming off the game clock.
Well, Coach Marley,
take 3 guys back in that painted area after that second free throw attempt.
Shipley quickly brings it up to his left, driving. Martin pulls back, and he hits it. Quickly to Russell, here we go again. It's a broken record, they're not following him yet. Oh, they haven't got him.
Oh, and a jump.
Ujo reaches in. That took a few seconds off the clock that they didn't get when they were trying to defend.
No, but I like the fact that you gave yourself an opportunity to get a steal rather than just blatantly fouling. There's still a lot of time left in this game, especially when some of those fouls were coming with 1:30 to go. Give yourself an opportunity in the backcourt to at least get a foul before you try to foul in the front court. Also, he's sawing them away now.
How crucial are these free throws, though? I mean, if he hadn't turned hot here after missing the first two in this string, this game would go real tough.
He had 3 guys back. Now he's got 4 guys back on defense to try to stop them from getting layups. You don't want to give up a 3, certainly, but certainly can't keep giving up layups.
Shipley driving, slashing, picked off. Russell up to Shaq Carr.
That just might do it right there. That might be the final nail. That turnover to a layup.
Oh, McCall, the career high. It's the 3.
This kid has having himself one whale of a basketball game. Just when I think they might have gotten the layup and that could have put the final nail in the coffin, they come back with a big 3.
Oh,
coach is upset.
Coach got a tee.
The Mustang coach is really upset about something that happened down at the other end, and I'm not quite 100% sure what it was, unless he thought that Shaq Carr might have traveled when he was going for that layup. It was an awkward jump that he had for sure. Didn't get the lift he wanted, but I certainly didn't think it was a travel. Hey, we get a look at that one again. Coach Calero is having no part of it, and that technical is really going to hurt his team with just 16.9 to go and a 4-point basketball, 4-point disadvantage. But look at here one more time. This is the steal that led to this opportunity for Shaq Carr. Count his steps here. 1, 2, 3. Maybe a big hop at the end of it, but not sure if it was a travel. But look at this one right back in the other way. But it's your night, it's your night. Set a career high. But did we get somebody going to the total lockers early?
That's Coach. Coach Calero.
Coach Calero going to the locker. Did he get a second technical that sent him to the locker room?
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness. Well, that'll do it then.
Mustangs really having lost 3 straight. Russell's been money at the free throw line after missing the first 2 on this long stretch.
Yeah, nobody moved because he's got a couple more free throws to shoot after that double technical.
Wow.
Hate to see this game in there with such a
Mustangs
kind of a negativity because it was such
pleased.
A good game.
It was, yep.
And Russell able to knock down 3 of those 4 free throw attempts, and the Lopes get the ball back. They can't advance it to half court, so they still got to worry about this tough Cal Poly defense and not commit a turnover here.
16.9 on the clock. Lead is 7. Martin to inbound. He can't find anybody. He's going to have to call timeout.
Well, they had 2, and that's a good situation there. That's the negative part about the college game, not being able to advance that ball to the half court line. You have a little bit more room to work with. When you get it down on that baseline, it's easy for everybody to overplay their man. Very small area in which to inbound the basketball, and actually the funny thing is the backboard works against you in that situation. You can't make the long pass over the top of the defense, so they just load up on you, play everybody in front, denying the passes.
GCU hitting their season average. It's just over 71 points per game. Inbound to Russell. This is beginning to be a broken record. He's being swarmed. Timeout was called.
Yeah, Martin called a timeout. He thought his buddy was in a bad way. And Russell's kind of looking at it like, nah, don't call a timeout. I got this. Two guys is nothing. But he didn't want a turnover, so being the coach on the floor, he used the final timeout of the game.
11.9 on the clock. Wolves, no doubt, on their way to winning their fourth straight. As they begin the first of two against Big West Conference opponents. Again, they'll be at UC Riverside December 31st, 3 p.m. tip. Tune in to Michael Potter, Tom Kuiper, 9:10 a.m. Let's revisit your three keys to the game, brought to you by Hyundai. Your Hyundai dealers here in the Valley, by Hyundai.com today.
Well, we talked about that three-point line. This is Mustangs team playing small ball, trying to run them off that three-point line. They were able to hit a couple, but not get killed. 5 of 16 from behind the arc. It was the penetrations here late in the basketball game that kept the Mustangs hanging around and make this an ugly basketball game. I think Lopes played some pretty good defense out there tonight. Really caught some fits, and then the Happy New Year. We not only put bench points up there, could have put anything up there, but more than anything, it's getting through this basketball game without getting any more Lopes players injured, and try to get some of those guys that are injured getting help, get them healthy for next year.
Inbound to Freer, quickly got it up to Russell, up for Fifi Adu. They're going to just walk it off, and the Lopes are going to win their ninth game of the season, improved to 7-2 on their home court, and win their fourth in a row. 71-64, the Lopes win.
Well, once again, it was one of those games that kind of started a little ugly in the first half, but the Lopes hit their stride in the second half, but they couldn't put this Cal Poly Mustang team away. They hung tough. They had a great performance tonight by Mickle, and Coach Marley be happy to have this win and close the book on 2016.
No doubt on their home court. Dwayne Russ with 20 points in the second half, many of them at the free throw line. Let's send it over to Kate.
All right, thank you, guys. Well, Coach, not necessarily the impressive numbers you're used to seeing from your team or the dominating play we've seen in the last couple of games, but your team grinding it out, finding a way to win. What to say about the guys you had on the court tonight?
It's a great win. I mean, that's a good team we beat. Really well coached, play hard, can shoot it. Defensively, we were pretty good. We battled, just found a way to win, and that's what we're trying to do, especially with the short bench and the guys we got. I'm really proud of our guys. That was good.
Yeah, it seems like it really sets the table. Obviously, you have Saturday's game at UC Riverside, week layover, and then WAC conference play starts. What are you anticipating?
Yeah, I mean, we've had a great home stretch, and now we get to go and see what we got against in the road, and then we've been looking forward to the moment for WAC play, and hopefully we'll have a couple guys back, Josh and Darian, but we'll have to see. But I'm proud of our guys. This was a big getaway win, especially when you got to go back out on the road.
All right. Well, thank you very much. Congratulations on the W. Wishing you all the best in 2017. Hopefully a lot of healthy bodies back as the Lopes take their sixth straight win here, their fourth straight win overall.
Yeah, Russell hitting his season average of 25 points. We'll step aside, be back to wrap things up after the Lopes win it, their fourth in a row. 71-64 over the Mustangs from Cal Poly.
There's a surge of excitement at GCU as the Lopes gear up for greatness. We do not accept defeat. We will not disappoint. We will not quit. We are the intensity brewing in the heart of Phoenix. We are the Lopes rising. Come watch us defend our house against Louisville, San Diego State, and rival New Mexico State. Catch all the family-friendly entertainment. Games will sell out. Get your basketball season tickets today at LopesTickets.com.
At GCU, earning your degree online doesn't have to be without the college experience. To find your purpose, it takes support from those around you. GCU's leadership offers over three decades of experience in delivering real-world degree programs online. GCU's online class size averages less than 17 students with full-time faculty. Find your purpose online at Grand Canyon University. Call us today at 855-428-7692. GCU offers more than 200 innovative programs across 9 colleges, which now include cutting-edge next-generation programs in engineering, computer science, and information technology. Grand Canyon University, the quality of a private Christian education, the affordability of a state university. Visit gcu.edu.
Take a look at the final stats after the Lopes win it 71-64. Field goal percentage 47.1. Free throws, wow, decisive, 20 of 32. Rebounding edge going to the Mustangs. Assists 12-9 in favor of the Lopes, and the turnovers 13 for the Mustangs, 9 for the Lopes. Gary Vitale, Scott Williams back with you. Well, it went down to the wire and then foul trouble, and Dwayne Russell, after missing the first two, was money after that. Right. A season average, 25.
You got a season average. It was a slow start. Remember, he only had 5 there in the first half, and most of those came early in the first half, so really picked it up, especially in that second half when game got really tight. It was at that 2-4, 4-6 kind of seesaw battle there for a while, and Russell just decided, I'm going to put the team on my back and carry us across the finish line.
Dwayne Russell, our player of the game with those 25 points, went to the free throw line. He was 12 of 17 in the game, and he was red hot when he needed to be.
Yeah, that was that early one in the first half. He banked it in. I don't know if he called bank or not, but I love the pull-up jumper. That's the one that got him going in the second half. That really got the defense off balance, knowing that he could pull up that mid-range jump shot. They had to play him a little tighter. They got some opportunities to drive to the basket. And once he gets guys on roller skates, it's just lights out from there. It's got them at their mercy.
There you see it, 25 points, 6 of 14 from the field. Free throw line, 12 of 17. Went there more than the Mustangs did as an entire team. As he spent a lot of time there in the last minute, less than a minute or so, to put this game away. Well, 4 in a row, they go out on the road. They take on another Big West opponent on the 31st. Then it's conference play, and this team, hopefully, Darian Clark's back. Josh Braun's back, and we're ready to rock and roll.
Yeah, you know, I wish them nothing but health and happiness and prosperity in the new year. These guys are phenomenal young men, and I'd like to see them at full strength to really see what they can do, because for the most part, we haven't had them at full strength all year long, and I know Coach Marley wants to see what he's got when all of his guys are out there and healthy. But, you know, Dwayne Russell, he was a really fun to watch in 2016. I'm looking forward to see what he has in 2017. Barry, I wish you and your family a very healthy and prosperous new year as well.
Happy new to you and to Kate and to everyone here at GCU. We want to extend our happy new year wishes to you and yours. The Lopes will be traveling back out of the road to California New Year's Eve for a quick roadie with UC Riverside. Be sure to tune into Fox Sports Radio 9, 10 a.m. and 3 p.m. for that game. Our next CW6 telecast of GCU basketball is January 7th for the start of Western Athletic Conference play. Head coach Mark Pope brings his much-improved Utah Valley Wolverines here to GCU Arena. You can catch Kate Longworth on the Lopes pregame show starting at 6:30 on the CW6, online at gcu.tv, or listen to Fox Sports 9, 10 a.m. Michael Potter, Tom Kuiper will have all the action. That'll do it from here at GCU Arena, where the Lopes beat the Mustangs 71-64. Please tune in to 9, 10 a.m. on Saturday. GCU traveling to UC Riverside. For Scott Williams, Kate Longworth, and our entire crew, I'm Barry Vitale, wishing you a safe and happy new year. Good night.